world in my locker.
Come on, Milford, we've been late every day this week.
Hang on, come in.
Look at the state here. You're unshaven again, scruffy. She's been gone 10 months now, buddy. You gotta move on.
I just wanna know what's happened to her, that's all. I need to know she's all right.
How many more times have we got to go through this? She did a moonlight flip. We would do it all the time.
Parker, she disappeared in the middle of the night. She went for a wee and I never saw her again. You can't tell me that's natural.
You just let it go, eh?
Easy for you to say. I still miss her.
I know you do, mate, but wake up. You're dreaming if you think she's coming back.
She might do. One day she could just walk through that door.
You're living in a fantasy world, Milford. This is the real world.
Just because you never experienced the love of a beautiful woman.
I think time's warping your perception, buddy. She was only beautiful.
No. Oh, here they are, the freak and his little boyfriend.
Bloody hell, it's soft skin.
Ignore him, keep walking.
Freak.
Oi, freaky boy!
Shut your fat mouth, soft skin.
Beg your pardon.
You heard him, soft skin. Shut it.
Oh, I'm sorry, Milford. I didn't mean to upset you. You 11-fingered freak.
What did you say?
I called you an 11-fingered freak.
Don't you ever get tired, Soskin?
Nah. Still, never mind. You two won't have to put up with me much longer.
What do you mean by that?
Well, you'll soon find out. Let's put it this way. If Santa got fired, he'd have to carry his P-45 and a sack.
What do you think he meant by that?
Look, ignore him. You know what Soskin's like. He's always talking riddles. Mm.
Would Milford and Parker please come to Mr. Pickering's office immediately? Thank you.
Oh, terrific.
Oh, what do you think that's all about? We've never been called up there before.
I don't know. Don't worry about it. Just let me handle him. Whatever he wants, I'll deal with it. Pickering's a pussycat. He's got to know where to stroke him.
Mm. You're fired.
You are? But Mr. Pickering...
Quiet, Parker! How dare you waltz in here an hour and... 33 minutes late, and assume he was to hear your voice.
I'm sorry, sir, but...
Quiet!
Thank you, Mr. Hanratty. Now, listen to me, you two. Pickering's Fine Furniture has been in business for 46 years, and I've been around soft furnishings man and boy, and there's a reason Pickering's is so successful. Hard graft. Something that you two lazy boys are obviously unaccustomed to.
Lazy boys. That's very good, sir.
Quiet, Hanratty. And this attitude is precisely why the two of you will never be the proud owners of a ride-on lawnmower or an 8-berth narrowboat, the Jenny Wren, currently moored at the Brass Street Base in Dudley.
Right, sir.
I tell you, you learn a lot in this game. And if I've learned nothing else, I've learned this. There comes a time in every man's life when he's called into his boss's office and is fired. And today is your turn.
What? Mr. Pickering, look, allow me...
Deaf as well as fired, Parker. You heard what Mr. Pickering said. You two have precisely 15 minutes to clear out your lockers and be off the premises. Now get out.
But oh, out! Done. Come on, let's go.
Well, that went well. Now what are we going to do? I've worked here since I was 13, Parker. I don't know how to do anything else. I mean, I just... Oh, no!
What? What's wrong?
My coin! It's gone out my locker! Someone's nicked it!
What coin?
My love coin.
Your love coin? Why would anyone want to nick your love coin?
It meant a lot to me, Parker, you know that. She gave me that outside the Flying Scotsman in Lorette de Mar.
Romantic.
Yeah. One half to me and she kept the other half for herself to wear for all eternity. Then we toasted our love with four massive jugs of Mai Tai.
Oh, no wonder she ran off. What's that noise?
Yeah, I hung it up in my locker this morning.
What?
When it came in.
What is that noise, Milford?
The door's still padlocked. So the door's still padlocked.
Milf, shut up. Sounds like there's a forest in your locker.
What? Oh, yeah, I noticed that on Monday.
What do you mean you noticed it on Monday, mate?
Yeah, weird. And on Tuesday, my trainers had all ivy on them. And yesterday, there was a vole in my lunchbox. He'd eaten my mini Battenberg.
What? You didn't need to mention this. You know, I love mini. Get out of the way. Let me have a look in there. This can't be right.
What?
Bloody hell.
What? What is it?
It's strange.
That's some kind of door. It's in the in the back here, look. Hang on, if I just...
Potter?
Oh, what's going on?
Potter?
Milford! I'm surrounded by those fingers of light. So blue, stroking me. Oh, it's caressing me.
Oh, I'll fetch the electrician.
It's calling me.
You're right in there, Parker. Parker? Oh, God. Where's he gone? Parker. Oh, he's right. There is a light. Parker? Parker, where have you gone?
It's so beautiful.
I can't see you. Where are you?
I'm here, Milf. On the other side. Come through. There is a forest. Don't be afraid.
Hey, look what we've got here, boys. It's the freak all on his own. What's he playing hide and seek with your little boyfriend? Here, counting up to 11, are you? I'll tell you what, if you're hiding, we'll give you a hand. Throw him in a locker, boys.
Get off,
go
man.
On. Oh, get him
down.
One, two, three. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Look at this. I don't think anyone uses this locker anymore, lads. Padlock it up.
All right.
That was surprisingly high.
Yeah, should have used them stairs.
Have a look at this place. Whoa! Well, this can't be right. This isn't Pickering's basement. I've been down there. It was full of plywood offcuts. Didn't have a waterfall.
Yeah, you're right. It never had a waterfall.
I don't get it. Parker, how can there be a forest in the back of my locker?
Listen, I'm no expert. Huh? I'm going to take a guess. We've stumbled through a sub-dimensional aperture into another world.
Right. That's a pretty wild guess.
Oh, look at the forest. It's enchanted, clearly.
How can you possibly tell it's enchanted?
All right, here they come. Black apples on the trees, number one. Uh-huh. A big bank of encroaching and mysterious fog, number two. And look down on the floor, a tiny group of mice putting on a play.
Oh, I hate theatre. Okay, point taken.
Listen, I've read The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe, and those books have taught me a thing or two, buddy. Mm-hmm. The trouble with enchanted forests is this, and I'm going to tell you what it is. There's always a right way to go, filled with wonder and magic.
Uh-huh, keep talking.
Okay, and then there's a wrong way to go, filled with pain, and you're almost certain death.
Oh, no, I don't... What do you mean, my death?
You know, I didn't mean your death specifically, I just meant almost certain death in general.
I'm starting to freak now.
Come on, have a breath. It's all right. We'll have a little look around, then we're going to go back. I promise you it'll be fine. You never know. This is a magical realm. You might even see a pixie.
Oh, yeah. Hey, might see a talking dragon.
Or a talking dragon.
Yeah. I just hope we don't bump into any unicorns, that's all.
What is it with you and unicorns? Why are you so frightened?
Because of that one I saw at Woburn Abbey. Huge, powerful thing. Wrote off Dad's Allegro.
It's a rhino, mate.
Same thing, innit?
It's not really.
Isn't it? What's a unicorn, then? Hey, look at this place. What's going on here?
Some kind of clearing. Someone set up a camp. There's a fire, a wigwam, a little washing line.
Oh, look. Look at the little clothes. A tiny tunic. Little leggings, the smallest hat ever.
Go on, put it on.
Leave my things alone! Who are you? Who sent you?
Look at him, Parker. He's so tiny. Oh, I want to pick him up and burp him.
Come on, come on then, come to Milford.
He's not a kitten.
He is?
No, I am not. Oh. What are you doing in my clearing?
Well, we just...
I am sorry, tiniest of men. Forgive my idiot. We come in peace and mean you no harm. We were lost and tired and stumbled upon your camp.
Hang on. He's wearing my necklace.
What?
That's my love coin. What are you doing with it? Give it back.
Oi, give it him back. That's his.
You are the owner of this amulet.
Yes, I am.
Yes, he is.
Oh, forgive me. It was not my intention to offend. I am no thief. Here, take it back.
Thank you.
Why have you got his necklace?
I merely happened upon it. I saw it glinting at me whilst in the parsnip patch.
Yeah, and what were you doing in the parsnip patch?
I was picking parsnips for broth. It is strange. I have seen a broken amulet such as yours once before.
Nah, not like this one, mate. Limited edition.
Yes, very similar indeed. It was just before the last fall of winter on the road to Drumharrow. A fair maiden indeed. I sold her 4 marrows. I couldn't help but notice her jewellery. And between you and me, her bosom was most flowery also.
Parker, did you hear that?
What?
That could be her.
Oh, don't be dull. Listen, I don't want to be rude, but he did say fair maiden.
But you heard what he was saying. She was wearing the...
What? What's wrong? What are you doing?
You!
What, me?
Yes, what? You! You have 11 fingers.
Don't you start.
Yeah, look, so what if I've got 11 fingers, yeah? I was born like it. Mum said I was special.
Indeed. Indeed, you are special. So the signs were true.
What signs?
The chosen one has come. Ha ha! The prophecy was right. He has come at last. He has come. Oh, the chosen one has come. The chosen one has come. Oh, happy.
Stop dancing about. What the hell are you talking about?
Who's come?
We have waited so long for this moment.
Sorry?
It is written in your...
In your what?
No, your. It means a long time ago.
Yeah, I knew that.
Hang on a second. How do you know us? Who are you?
I am Marmite. What?
Oh, nothing. It's just that where we come from, Marmite's a beef-enriched breakfast spread ideally suited for toast.
Here also, but that is my name. I am Marmite, son of Lobo, master of the ancient forest of Blue Bean.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Marmite.
Nice? To meet me? Oh, thank you. My lord, oh, thank you.
Why are you calling me that?
My lord, because you are the one.
The one?
Yes, you are the chosen one. Don't you know? You have been sent here to release the Dark Lord's tyrannical grip upon this fragile realm.
OK, you're clearly a nutcake, so we're off.
Not so fast. Please allow me to reveal all over dinner.
Dinner. Now you're talking our language. I suppose you're going to bring down a mighty stag or the old singing bow that you've probably got. Maybe a hunk of rustic cheese from your knapsack, or washed down with some kind of reviving elven fruit ale. Am I right, eh? I'm right.
I shall take you to a restaurant.
Yeah, all that. You buy us dinner, and then we'll shoot off. Right, Milf?
Yeah, dinner. Nice.
Good, then let us away to the restaurant!
It's nice.
Hey guys, how you going? I'm Charlene. I'll be your waitress tonight.
Oh.
You don't sound local.
Nah, just bumming around for you before uni's and that, you know?
Nice one. Yeah, I did a bit of travelling myself during my gap year and, sadly, I got a bit into a pulp after a card game turned sour in Northern Laos.
I, picked hops in Kent.
So, you ready to order, guys?
Shall we get a few starters?
Ooh.
I think the Lord of the Onion Rings, Nacho Supremo, just a basket of deep-fried Gandalf hats,
hey.
Please.
I'll have the Snapple Jack stew, please.
Nice. And for you, kind sir.
Tell me, do you have sausage and chips?
One Outlander special, darling. Okay, guys, shouldn't be too long.
Oh, what's happening now?
Ah, the entertainment is about to begin. They have a different turn every night. Last night, Shorty the Dwarf brought the house down with his impression of a giant. And tonight's music night, not sure who's on, actually.
There it is. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, welcome. You all know me. I'm the manager here at Frodo's, Terry Salmon. like the fish. Although, unlike the fish salmon, I won't actually die after mating. You'll have to trust me on that one, ladies. Right, well, if you haven't already ordered, you may like to try a bowl of our famous Snapplejack stew. It's the only dish on the menu that bites back. Really, it does actually bite back. Right, well, there it is, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, Frodo's is, of course, a non-heckling venue. So, without further ado, please put your hands together and your feet and your claws and welcome on stage the deliciously jazzical Diamond Knights.
All right, two. Oh, a little more of a vocal monitor there. Two, that's cool. Okay, ladles and gel spoons, this is your groove captain speaking. Hold on to your hats, this may just get funky!
I love this place.
Oh, you know what? It's really nice. The music, the dancing dwarves. I've never been to a TGI Frodo's before. So, Marmite, you mentioned a prophecy.
The prophecy. Yes, of course. The prophecy. Very well. The tale I'm about to tell begins long ago. It is a tale so ancient that only the sky now fully remembers.
Old Ben.
It is the tale of the sofa of time.
The what?
The sofa of time.
You might have thought of a better title, mate.
Shush, Parker. I love stories.
Good. Our tale begins long ago with a very powerful but very old warlock named Moran. For hundreds of years, Moran lived in his mighty castle, looking down upon his domain. From horizon to horizon, and from seabed to mountain top, it was all his. However, one great happiness eluded Moran, that of simple comfort. Remember, this tale is from a time when thrones were hewn from solid stone.
The olden days.
Precisely. Moran spent a lifetime attending to the needs of his beloved Gravish.
The what?
The Gravish. Us, people from Gravier. That is where you are, Gravier.
Yeah, Gravier. Carry on.
So, in all that time, Moran never once gave any thought to his own comfort. But after the ninth and last great war had ended and the harvests came once again, he found that his people no longer needed his magic.
Well, that's a bit ungrateful.
Indeed, my lord. So, Moran had no choice but to return to his castle where he found himself to be alone. Alone and uncomfortable.
I think I know where this is going.
Hush, you!
Yeah, don't ruin it, Parker. I don't know where it's going. Please, Marmite, continue with your tale.
Thank you, my lord. The prophecy said you would be wise.
Cheers.
Why? What are you talking about? It's so obvious what's coming next. This Moran bloke, he's gonna
Shut
build...
Shut filthy mouth, or I'll open you up like a tin of beans.
I'm sorry.
Very well. So, after rattling around a big old stone castle on his own with never a comfortable place to sit, Moran could take no more. He summoned the land's best and finest craftsmen, the Safarians.
Ha
ha! What, like rusters?
No, the Safarians are a race of skilled upholsterers, carpenters and tanners. Moran instructed them to build him a brand new throne, one that was long enough for him to lay down on if he fancied, and padded. It must be luxuriously padded. And so they did, carving the legs from oak and pepper wood, fashioning buttons from gold and gems, and weaving fairy hair into the finest cloth, until eventually they were ready to unveil their sumptuous creation.
It's the sofa, yeah? Am I right?
In Moran's chamber, the throne was finally revealed. Moran was overjoyed. He swung his feet up and snuggled down into the soft mouse leather pillows, where he fell fast asleep.
And come on, Milf, let's go home. I've had enough of this.
Wait.
Yeah, just hang on, Parker. What's wrong with you? Two more minutes. I want to know what happens.
But while Moran slept, he had a dream, a terrible dream. A prophet angel came to him and told him of the future, a future of war and death. And some famine. A future in which a dark lord would rise and our world Gravier would die.
Oh, yeah, this bloke eat a lot of cheese.
I don't know.
In the dream, the angel told Moran that only one man could save the world. A man who would come when Gravia needed him most. A man innocent of heart with 11 fingers.
Oh, this is... I've had enough of this.
Parker, just wait. He's talking about me.
Oh, amazing.
Marmite, what happened to the wizard, Moran?
Oh, it pains me to recall even now, my lord. Poor Moran was out walking one night when a moon fell on him.
You what? The moon fell on him?
No, a moon, just a little one, a couple of feet across.
This is bloody ridiculous. That's the worst prophecy I've ever heard. It doesn't explain anything. What's the significance of the sofa? How do you know all this?
It is written.
Written? If this Moran bloke died, who wrote it?
Ah, well, he was found close to death by his footman.
Yeah, with a moon sticking out of his head.
No, he was taken back to his castle where he was laying upon the sofa. A scribe was summoned and Moran told him of his dream, making him promise to write the words down, okay?
Ignore him, Marmite.
Hey, guys, how you going? You all done?
Oh, yeah, thanks.
How was it?
Oh, it was delicious, thank you.
Yeah, my stew actually frightened me a bit.
Oh, think yourself lucky. Killed a lady last week. Desserts, anyone?
No, thanks, I'm full.
No, thank you.
It's a no on the dessert, my love, but can we say yes, please, to a trio of cafe lattes?
No worries. Won't be long.
Thanks.
Right, our tale is now thundering towards its thrilling denouement. The sofa of time! A powerful piece of furniture indeed.
Why is it called the sofa of time?
Ah, for when Moran died, so comfortable was he that all his powers bled into the sofa. Every golden stitch, every jewelled button positively throbbed with his life force. It was that life force that gave the sofa its power. The power to travel to any time, to any world, and in any dimension.
Shit.
And you know what that means? In the wrong hands, the sofa of time is a very powerful weapon indeed.
Oh, why's that?
Think about it. If the sofa were to be used for evil, whoever wields its magic could journey into the past and destroy his enemies before they were even born.
Oh, so the baddies could kill all the goodies?
Well, that's a little simplistic, but essentially, yes.
And this is where we come in, is it?
Well, not so much you, but...
You're good, mate. I'll give you that. You got all the tricks. Come on, Milford. Get your jacket. We're off.
Parker, just hang on. I need to know one more thing. Marmite, where's the sofa now?
It was hidden a long time ago. Nobody really knows, but here's the thing. I fear it may soon fall into the hands of the foulest, most treacherous Emperor Warlock to threaten Gravia in 1,000 years.
An Emperor Warlock?
Oh, yeah, who's that then?
His name is... Ramon Bord.
Push that door to him, would you, Leslie?
Of course, Your Excellency. Why so glum, Master?
Oh, I wish I could get my hands on that sofa. If only I knew where it was, I could gain control of its magic and the whole world would be mine. Nothing could stop me. Legions would fall to their knees, and I would take my rightful place at the center of the universe.
It is a shame. Tea?
Please. Oh, and Leslie.
Your Excellency?
Leave the door open.
Parker! Come back! Listen to what he's got to say. These people need our help.
Milford is asking us to battle his world's vilest nutcases. It's like us fighting Hitler.
Yeah, exactly. And if we don't help them, they'll all be dead. Just like poor old Mr. Hitler.
No way. No way. I'm going home. I'm going back to that portal. And tomorrow morning, I'm going to beg for my job back. This is not our problem.
Just let him go. The prophecy didn't mention him anyway.
Look, he's my only friend. Wait here, Marmite. Look, just let me talk to him.
Remember, our world is at stake.
Please, Parker. Come back. Just stop. Listen to me for a second. What is there to go back for? Hey, we've lost our jobs, which is good because everyone hated us anyway. At least here there's no Pickering, no Hanratty, there's no Soskin. We've got respect here.
You've got respect here.
Yeah, I have.
It's the first time ever. You know what? I kind of like the feeling. You never know. Might be fun.
Fun?
Fun? You're out of your mind. We're talking about fighting an evil warlock. You're not even good with confrontation. What happened when you wrote that letter of complaint to Debenhams?
I didn't post it.
You didn't post it, exactly. And what was that over? A fitted sheet? What this tiny freak suggesting, mate, it's suicide. No way, forget it.
Please, Parker, please. I really need this.
Come on.
You know how flat I've been since you went away?
It's a cheap shot.
I know. But you heard what Marmite said about the necklace? A fair maiden with a coin like mine? What if it was her? I need to know.
I know you do. All right. You know what?
What?
I'm going to give it a week.
What? You really mean it?
Yes. Must be going bonkers, but okay, we'll do it. 1 week. Terrific. I guess I don't have much of a choice now, do I?
Oh, look, thanks, Parker. Thank you. You know what? I love you, man.
Get off!
Has a decision been reached? Will the two of you journey with me to claim back the sofa of time?
Parker? Are you sure?
Yes.
Oh. Yes!
Oh!
Marmite, we accept the challenge.
Oh, you do? You do?
Yes.
Oh, hooray, hooray, hooray. I have waited so long for this moment. Oh, I am so very happy. This is the greatest day of my life. Oh, yeah. Oh, what say we go and get pissed?
Yes.
You know what, Marmite? That's the best thing you've said all day.
You've been listening to The Sofa of Time. It starred Matt King, Nick Frost, Mark Heap, Peter Serafinowicz, Kevin Eldon, Janie Anderson, Daisy Jones. It was written by Matt King and Nick Frost. The producer is Mario Stilianides. Where the brave go shopping.
Oh, there you are. Morning.
Oh, hello. Now, firstly, I've got a massive hangover. And, why are you so big?
I'm not big, mate. You're tiny. That's why you slept in my pocket. Look at him, Mum.
I can't see anyone.
Shut up. You want to tell me what's going on? Why am I little?
It is your own fault, Parker. I told you not to drink so much.
Listen, mate. Where I'm from, drinking a lot does not make you shrink. It's your crime.
You did your fair share of that last night, too. The inside of my pocket's soaking. Your tears stink.
They weren't tears, you idiot. I wet myself.
You were drinking cloven hoof, Parker. The more you drink, the tinier you get. You should have read the small printing.
Oh, yeah. Whoop it up, you little pipe smoker. How long's this going to last? I'm like a bloody action man.
Look, apparently it's a bit like a hangover. You'll get bigger as the day goes on.
I'd better. Sorry, just one more question, quick one. Why are we on a raft heading for a massive thunderous whirlpool?
We're going into town!
Just got to change some money and get a few bits and bobs.
Right. Good. So why are we heading for a massive thunderous whirlpool?
You'll find out, just hold on!
You know what? I'm not sure I want to find out. Put me ashore!
Oh, grow up!
What a rush!
Rush, that was awful. Where are we? Why are we sitting in this fountain?
This fountain, as you call it, is an aquastop. We have journeyed a long way. We are now in Lower Tangleton. Travelling this way is cheap and very popular in this part of Gravier. There's this stop in Market Square, and there's another down on Cinnamon Street, opposite Swords and Slacks.
I have to say, I prefer the old route master.
You weren't scared, were you?
No, I wasn't scared. Just get me out of this pocket.
All right, all right. Oh, what's this? Oh, no, we must have gone so deep we hit the bottom. Your pocket's full of clay. Oh, your trousers are covered in it, Parker. Covered in clay.
Oh, yeah. That's what it'll be. Clay. It's clay.
Enough of this. We must away to the Bureau de Change.
Yeah, is there somewhere private I can have a little wash up?
Forgive me, sir, but I could not help but overhear. I am Tortoise Gedge, a powerful local clay merchant, and I am willing to offer a handsome sum for that clay caked upon your breeches.
Word to the wise, buddy. It ain't clay.
Ah.
Come along, you two. Don't dilly-dally.
Put me back in your pocket, would you, Mel?
Come on, then.
Not that one.
Cashier number one, please.
I don't believe it. You've got a nerve showing your face in here, Mamitius.
And you've got more nerve showing me a face like that.
Oh, blimey, here we go.
If you're not careful, little man, mine will be the last face you ever see.
Yes, well, if the last face I ever see is to be yours, then I might just go and kill myself now. Sir?
You've lost none of your gift for comedy, old friend. Come, come, give Papa Mbombay cuddle.
You two know each other?
Know each other? This is Papa Pierre Babyface Mbomba, my oldest and dearest friend. We did national service together back in 25.
I was his sergeant, for all the notice he took of me. Fine soldier, but no discipline. I had him peeling so much boom bread fruit, his fingers were invisible for weeks.
Tough old husk, the boom bread fruit, tough old husk.
Miriam! Shut up shop, woman!
But it's only 1 o'clock, please.
You heard me, woman! My friend is here!
Shutting up shop now, please.
Honestly, she is the most troublesome robot wife I have ever had. Except, of course, for Shiva 250.
Ooh, now there was a woman.
Indeed, indeed. So, what brings you to this part of Gravia, old friend? It must be something serious to bring you this far north.
It is serious, my proud ebony warrior. As you know, the land of Gravier is under threat once again. I fear that Ramon Bod is close to discovering the resting place of the Sofa of Time.
Sweet Butalesi! No! Does he have it yet?
No, but the Hackett are on the march. It is only a matter of time.
Oh, my old friend, this news is indeed grave. A storm is beginning to rage. I feel it in my claw.
Relax, for I have a powerful secret weapon.
You haven't got a loo I can use, have you?
Busting.
Behold, the chosen one.
This must be some kind of crazy game you're giving me, Marmite. Him? The chosen one? I don't have time for this.
No, it is true. Look at his left hand.
I don't believe it. He has 11 fingers. He's so creepy. Then the prophecies are true. My lord, this is a great honor.
Oh, the honor's all mine, sir.
So, my mate, tell me, where do I fit in? How can I help?
We need to change some money.
That's all. This, my friend, I can do. Tell me, what have you got?
Parker?
£1.40.
£1.40! Miriam, summon Whispering Andy.
Summoning Whispering Andy now, please.
Okay. Business time.
Mum, who's whispering Andy?
He's the money changer. Watch.
Bloody hell!
Keep your voice down. This game off.
Good afternoon, Andy. Andy says,
hello.
Andy, my friends here need to change some money. What's today's exchange rate for sterling into gravish francs?
Today we're buying at 26.7 to the
pound. Andy, thank you. You may go. I'll see you in the Shepherd's at 8. So, taking into consideration all the variables, £1.40 will get you 38 million gravish francs. Minus my commission gives you a grand total of a little over 7 million.
Oh, that sounds all right.
A very tidy sum.
Hold on, is that a Turkish lira 7 million or, you know, the good 7 million?
Well, for, say, 10 francs, you could get a fried blue eel, a flagon of ale, and a night in the Tangleton Ramada.
But hang on.
You're telling me...
That we're...
That I'm...
Rich!
We're rich!
In headlines again, the writer, actor and showbiz personality Giganticus has died. He was 94 feet tall. The former host of popular game shows 2x2 and The Armor Game was found late last night by his lifelong partner, Titanicus. And now, with news of all the latest sport, Susie and Tantor.
Feetball! Blacktooth Town continue their dominance by knocking 100
Turn
in against
off,
Robinson
you,
FC.
Leslie?
Of course, Your Excellency.
Oh, that's a shame about Giganticus, isn't it?
Yes.
I used to love 2x2.
No, me too, you know that.
Do you remember we used to rush home from evil school and lay in front of the telly and your mum would cook us tea?
Yes, algae and chips every day. Mum used to say we'd turn into blooming algae if we weren't careful.
Oh, the irony.
Indeed.
And then at 5 to 5 on Friday night, it had come on. How did the theme tune go again?
Don't you remember? They go in 2x2
Always makes... A pair! Right. Back to business. Now, Liz, anything to report?
Not much, Your Excellency. I just got the daily civic logs in. Nothing, really. The markets look pretty solid. Bloodstick juice is up 0.5 point. They've implemented the new toll charges at the Gates of Fire.
Good.
Somebody's just changed up some money in Tangleton. Pound sterling, £1.40.
What? That's a lot of money.
38 million francs, to be precise.
38 million?
Yes.
I'm not sure I like this lately. Somebody out there has just become very rich indeed.
£38 million
gravish
francs.
A
lot of money. We are so rich.
No. I'm so rich. I'm rich. I'm so rich.
Oh, stop going on. You should put that money in a purse, you know.
Mum, listen. Why are all those people staring at us?
Your eyes are that of a Cermat, my lord. These are poor and simple folk, impoverished by years of Ramin Bod's rule. They've never seen so much money.
Oh, yeah? Well, I ain't getting none of it.
I hope you're right. But bear in mind, there are creatures in this village who'd tear you a new a-hole for a tenth of what's in that sack.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'd like to see them try. Oh, why have I got a poisoned eye in my face? Why would anyone want to kill me?
I told you to put it in a purse. Purse.
Parker!
You're fine.
Parker!
You're fine.
You're meant to actually punch the time clock.
It is a tale so ancient that only the sky now fully remembers.
She's left me!
The sofa!
Parker?
Hmm.
Parker?
Oh. Oh God, so nice.
You all right?
Ooh, yeah, man, just wicked, really wicked. Just kind of chilling, feeling groovy.
What are you talking like that for?
Like what, Hepcat?
Like that? Mum, why is he talking like that?
Oh, forget it, man, he's just high.
Yeah, I'm high. High, man, like this little fella says, I'm high. Like the moon, I feel like a giant, yeah? Oh, like a massive moon giant.
You're just back to normal size.
Where are we?
We are in a darkened alleyway off the main street. You were dragged here by Whispering Andy. It was lucky he was passing. He spoke to them in a normal voice and they ran off terrified.
Who did?
You were set upon by a gang of scobble.
Scobble?
Yes. The Scobble are terrifying. A race of genetically bred elite prison guards who are stationed aboard the prison hulk, Golga. A place without hope, without reason, and without sanity.
Oh, sounds a bit like Jerry's hostel in Taipei.
What about that bloke? What was the German fella's name?
Klaus.
Klaus, when he threw that melon off the roof of the bamboo barn, oh. Quang Mao came out. He went,
you nah. Should not take the Scobble so lightly. They are the foulest of creatures. You even look one in the eye, you will scream until your mind falls off.
Blimey.
Shut up.
Why'd they shoot Parker?
Because of that bag of money. They come up here a couple of times a year on shore leave and they go nuts on hookers and cheap Jalvian brandy and then they fight. We are lucky they didn't see the extra finger, my lord.
Oh, why's that?
And they are in league with Ramon Bod. He owns the Golga. He pays their wages. They'd have grassed you up for sure. I fear it is no longer safe here. Our quest must begin in earnest. Come! We have just one more stop to make.
But, Your Excellency, I bring news from the sweltering north.
Can I just stop you there? Did you read the small sign that I etched and affixed to the door?
Yeah.
Yes, what?
Oh, yes, Your Excellency.
Good. And what do you think the small sign that I etched and affixed to the door said?
It said, if you can hear me, Piani... Please, guys, don't come in here.
And could you hear my piano?
Yeah, maybe a bit, but my blankets tend to drown out some of the noise, and then I've got these big leather flaps on the helmet.
Silence! Cast yourself into that lava chamber, would you?
Oh, this one here?
No. The one behind it. Chamber G.
Here?
No, the big one. Keep going.
Mm-hmm.
Keep going.
Uh-huh.
Keep going.
Mm.
That one.
Oh, that is quite a big one.
Hmm.
Am I allowed to step over the velvet rope side?
Oh, yeah. Just, jump over.
Hmm. Okay. Shall I take the important message to my grave, or maybe I'll just tell you now, you know? Last words of a... dying man and all that.
All right, then, quickly.
Okay, I'm paraphrasing here, but a double-tailed comet streaking across the northern night sky. A cat gave birth to a puppy with a child's face. And finally, an 11-fingered man spotted in Tangleton.
What? An 11-fingered man, you say?
No, it's quite weird. I'm certainly no sage, but... You do the math. It seems the ancient prophecies are coming true. But, you know, don't shoot the messenger, as the old saying goes. Of course, you're not going to shoot me anyway, are you? You're going to burn me up in the old lava chamber there.
Has this ever happened to you?
Help me! I got monkey rats in my town!
Well, no more! Be a DIY hero guy by paying a visit to Bravemart. Here at Bravemart, we have everything for the experienced and novice hero alike. Thousands of new, nearly new, and reconditioned swords and axes. I got pikes, I got trebuchets.
And what about siege cannons?
Well, you're telling me you want a siege cannon? I got siege cannons! You want potions and spells? We got the answers. Beautiful enchantments from as low as 1 franc each. Jiggery pokery, 2 francs a planet. Summon a chocolate box drift of snow at will. Just a penny a flick. Bravemart! The place where zeros can become heroes.
Bravemart, just off the M9 between Tangleton and Lava Lake.
Whew! This place is amazing. Do you know, I think it's bigger than Peace and World in Statewood Corner.
Are you nuts?
Come along, we must make haste. We've both got a list, you know what you're looking for.
Right then, getting tooled up. Come on then, you, give me that list. I'll take care of the weapons and that. And why don't you, mister, go look for a nice little helmet for yourself.
How come you get to do the weapons?
I'll meet you in the Waffle Experience and say... half an hour?
Fine. See you later.
All right, bye-bye, mate. Right, right, longbows. Langbows. Lingbows, lingbows. Here we are. Longbows, now.
I've got a longbow. Which one should I choose?
Pick me! Oh. Me! Pick me!
Oh, talking bows! Good lord, this place gets better and better. Alright, one at a time. You, why should I pick you?
Because I'm a good girl and I fare straight and true. And because I'm made from enchanted mugger honey.
Oh, you mean mahogany?
Yeah.
What's your name?
I don't got a name.
Oh my god, you're so cute. Do you want to come with me? Shall I buy you and give you a name?
Yes, please.
Oh, there you go. How do you like the name Kelly?
Kelly. Kelly's a pretty name. Can I kill something now?
Kelly, don't be so naughty.
Sorry, I am a bow after all.
So you are. The cutest bow in the world.
Right, helmets. Ha! Helmets. Right, helmets that repel rocks. Boiled leather helmets. Oh, moon helmets.
May I be of assistance to you, sir?
Oh, hello.
Let me take a guess. You're looking for a helmet?
Yeah, I am. I'm not really sure what I want.
I hope you don't mind me saying so, sir, but you have a very fragile-looking head.
Oh, really?
It's like an egg, sir.
Right.
I could probably crush it myself with a toffee hammer and feed on the soft mush within. No problem at all.
you're not going to, though, are you?
Oh, sweet Maureen, no, sir. Now, put your head in my hands.
OK, I'm all yours.
No, I mean literally, sir.
Oh, right, that's right.
That's it. Now, give me a look at that thing.
Yeah.
Now, I would say you're an extra small.
Oh, really?
Tiny head, sir. How many ideas would a thing like that hold? 2, 3?
Usually 3.
You may only have 3 thoughts, sir, but I can't help noticing. You've got 11 fingers.
Oh, right, yeah. I was born like it. Mum said I was special.
Special indeed, sir. You are so special. I've got a little gift for you.
Oh, really?
It's been here a long time. I keep it in my special cupboard full of special things.
Oh.
Come this way, sir.
Right.
Yeah, we took the
barge out for the weekend, moored up at Great Grebe, and had a lovely pub lunch at the Braying Heifer. Well, you know how stubborn Dad is. Now, listen, Phil, I need interceptor darts, fluvin tipped. No, have you got the 40mm with the fragmented shafts? Yes, that's them. Can I have a dozen boxes of 200?
Marmite, Marmicious, get your tiny ass up here!
Oh, he spotted me. Sorry, Phil, could you just sort me out 10 rumble stones, good and round? Half a dozen thinking eggs? And a 50mm bottle of Mammy's milk. I'll be back in 2 ticks.
Marmite, now!
I'm coming!
Come!
Afternoon, Pinochle.
Don't Pinochle me. What the hell do you think you're doing? I've just been talking to my helmet head.
To your what?
The head of my helmet department. He tells me one of his assistants is serving a man with 11 fingers.
Well, he's a shop after all.
You know what I mean, Marmite. Is this man the chosen one?
When you say chosen...
I say again, is this man the chosen one?
Yes, he is.
Damn it, Marmite! Do you know what would happen if a Hackett patrol came through here and found this man in my store? They'd shut me down and then feed me and my beautiful family to a tannodak! Would you like to see Helen and the kids fed to a tannodak, Marmite?
No, of course not.
Then get that man out of my shop! Hello! What? Here? How many? Give him a complimentary waffle pass and keep him talking. Too late. Hackett, they're here. Get your men and get the hell out of here. You can take my transport. It's on the roof. Here.
Oh, thank you, Pinochle.
Now go! And believe me, Marmite, if Helen and the kids are eaten, I'll find you and spread you on my toast.
Hey, honey.
Go!
Kids, soldiers, get your stuff. We have to leave now. Where's Milford?
I don't know. You tried the ball pond?
Yes, I've tried the ball pond. We have to leave.
Oh, but I haven't had my Pinochle ten stack.
Go now. Wait for me. Up on the roof. I'm going to find him.
Right.
Oh, you. Stop.
Ah, here we are, sir. This may come as a surprise to you, sir. I know exactly who you are and exactly what you need.
All right. Listen, really flattered, but I'm not gay.
No, no, sir. I'm referring to your helmet.
Yeah, like I said.
Where is it? Here it is, sir. There she be. The glass helm of Port Luck!
Oh, it's amazing. What does it do?
It's a head!
Oh, I'll buy it!
Yes.
My lord, there you are! The Hackett are upon us!
Marmite, where's Parker?
He's on the roof. We must join him immediately. There is transport waiting for us in readiness for our escape.
Would you like a helmet, sir? I've got a nice little chrome dome that would sit just right on your head. Protect you from absolutely anything.
Oh. There you are. Yeah. Found him then.
Quickly, climb aboard.
Oh my God, what is this thing? It looks like a giant finch.
It is a finch. Bullfinch, actually. Pirula, pirula.
Everybody get aboard. Oh, and buckle up. These finches can shift.
They're firing at us!
Mighty Bullfinch, take us to Moran's castle!
Not your helmet. Oh, works well, I know.
Thanks, man.
Can I kill somebody now? Please, can I kill somebody?
Who said that? I nearly forgot. Everybody, meet my brand new longbow, Kelly. Come on, you, fire away.
Yay!
Blimey, you're cute and frighteningly accurate.
I done a murder.
You certainly did do a murder.
Good one, Kelly. Nice shot.
Who'd have thought it? This morning I was the size of a mouse,
Now I'm sitting on a massive bird.
Parker! Parker, no! Oh, my pocket's fallen off!
I told him to buckle up.
Parker!
You've been listening to The Sofa of Time. It starred Matt King, Nick Frost, Mark Heap, Peter Serafinowicz, Kevin Eldon, Julia Deakin, Janie Anderson, Joseph Marcel, Daisy Jones and Andrew Maxwell. It was written by Matt King and Nick Frost. The producer is Mario Stilianides. And the Hackett march on.
All right, we've got to stop soon. I think Puff is dying.
Oh, really?
He did fall a pretty long way. That was 3 days ago. I think he might have septicemia. His legs smell of cheese.
Stop rotting at
me. Sorry. Please, Mama, can we stop?
All right, put him down. I'll have a look at him. Parker, can you hear me? What are your symptoms?
My femur has snapped and is sticking out of my thigh. Oh. Vertebrae 2 through 8 are shot, and I have got a shard of clavicle lodged in my Adam's apple. Oh.
And your feet are the wrong way round.
Hmm? Oh, yeah. And my feet are the wrong way round.
Oh, no, Marmite, what are we going to do? Look at the state of him. Oh. I'm finding it quite disturbing.
Can I finish him off?
Not yet, Kelly. He may live.
You must be able to do something to help him.
Well, I didn't really want to, but... I'm joking. My lord, would you reach into my knapsack? There is a tiny bottle there labelled Mammy's Milk.
This one?
Thank you. This is your own fault, you silly sod. I told you to buckle up, didn't I? Now drink this. It'll make you feel alive again.
Is he all right?
Not really. He fell more than 180 feet, and if he hadn't landed on that plastic crocodile, he'd be dead.
Come on, mate. It's going to be okay. Hold my hand. That's it. Come on. Shush. We'll get through this. Come on, buddy. There you go. You okay?
Yeah, did not.
I tell you, it's good to have you back. If it wasn't for Marmite, you'd be a goner. You should thank him, really.
Yeah, thanks.
What? What's that? I didn't hear you.
Thank you, Marmite, for saving my life. How's that? You happy?
You're welcome, Parker. Now come along, we have work to do.
How are you feeling now, buddy?
I'm shattered, mate, I'm shattered.
Kelly wanted to finish you off.
Did she, Kel?
No, I did not.
You did, didn't you?
Yeah, a little bit. I wanted to pump a harrow into your mind.
Calm down.
It's not much further. We'll see the ruins from the top of this next rise.
What's that, what's that noise, Marmite? Sounds like... puffins or terns roosting.
You're a big puffin fan, aren't you, Mill?
Oh, yeah. Cracking seabird. It's a smashing sight to see a puffin swooping over the breaking surf, bill full of silvery sprats.
Oh, it's a lovely image you're painting. I'm more of a lakes man myself. Mm. Swanage Cove 87 was when I saw my first great crested grebe. It's a shy bird, the grebe. When she flashed that crest of hers, it set the hide alight, I can tell you.
I hate to disappoint the two of you, but the noise you can hear is neither puffin nor grebe.
Tons.
Tits?
No, tis children. Hundreds of them.
Kids? What are they doing here?
It's half term, the place will be packed with the little bastards. Come on. One child, please.
And how old are you?
8.
Are you sure? You're pretty swarthy for an 8-year-old.
Of course I'm sure. 2.5, please, young lady.
All right, then. Want headsets?
No, thank you. I know my way around. Right. Follow me. Stick close.
Hang on, Marmite. You haven't told us why we're here yet.
Listen. Some years ago, whilst I was here mapping the North Chamber, I unearthed a secret. An ancient stone upon which is an imprint of a hand. A six-fingered hand. I believe this stone is, in fact, the last of the great lock stones. Shall I go on?
Not bothered, really.
Yeah, carry on, Marmite. I'm interested.
The lockstones are a very powerful form of magical protection. They were used during ancient times to make safe valuables. You know, things like precious artifacts, spells, gems.
Yeah, a sack of magical hats.
Yes, or one of them.
Yeah, all right. So where do we come in?
Well, a lockstone with a six-fingered key. Think about it. We have Milford, who also has six fingers.
Oh. No, we don't.
What? Where's he gone? He was just here.
He's probably wandered off. He does that in museums.
Oh, no, I pray that is all that's happened. If he were to fall into the hands of our enemy, it would be disastrous for Gravier, perhaps even fatal. Ooh,
listen, don't worry, don't worry. I think I know where he'll be. Follow me.
Mummy, look at that poor man's baby.
I am not a baby!
Yeah, right, so I've got Mum, the tea towel depicting the ruins at sunset, and a box of magic fudge. And Parker's got the snowstorm with a real storm inside it. He'll love that. And for Marmite, the giant pencil. It's going to be bigger than him.
So that comes to 8 francs plus tax, so the total is 25 francs 50, please.
Jesus Christ! That's steep. I thought Haringey Council were bad. Whoever sets your taxes should be blooming shot.
Can't say that in here, love. That's classed as treason.
What are you whispering for? Your taxes are too high. Way too high.
I don't think you look like a baby. Oh, there he is.
Oh. Why is everyone in the shop looking at you, Milford?
I don't know. All I said was that I thought these people were paying way too much tax.
He said it again.
I think you should grab your big pencil and your fudge, shut your big old mouth and come outside.
All right, don't be rude. I've completed my transaction anyway, thank you, miss.
Just leave.
Mummy, that man had 11 fingers.
Oh, Jimmy, it's talk like that got Daddy taken away.
Look, Mama, I got you this unnecessarily large pencil. And Parker, Moran's Castle snowstorm.
Give me that.
Oh, don't throw. What'd you do that for?
Do you realise how many people are taken away and never seen again for doing exactly what you just did?
What, buying a massive pencil?
No, I'm referring to your loose chatter. Rahman Bod has spies everywhere. If your little tax outburst hadn't got back to him by first sundown, I'll be amazed. You still haven't realised who you are and why you're here. If you die, then Gravier dies with you. Simple as that. Do you want to be responsible for the deaths of millions?
Not overly, no.
Then follow me.
And thanks for the pencil.
Marmite shouted at you. You're in trouble again. Just like in the real world.
Shut up.
Quickly.
Come in, Marmite.
It is here that I found the lockstone all that time ago. It'll be overgrown by now. Look amongst the undergrowth. Parker, you take that corner. Mm-hmm. Milford, you look over there.
Check. I found it.
Oh, no.
It's a magazine. Goblin.
Here it is. Right, let's try and open it. My lord, would you?
Eh? How am I going to open it?
Well, what do you notice about the handprint on the lockstone?
A very short lifeline.
Really? Yes, well, apart from that, anything else?
Oh, it's got six fingers. Like my hand.
Exactly. Well done, my lord. Well done indeed. Fantastic powers of deduction.
Marmite, do you remember earlier when Milford nearly killed millions of people?
That was before. I like him again now, and I don't like you again.
Right, so hang on. Let me get this right. I've somehow got to get this lock open. Open. Ooh, okay.
So obvious. Haven't you seen Total Recall?
To be honest with you, Parker, I don't totally recall.
I know how to open it. I'll just smash it with this rock here.
No!
Yeah.
There you go.
Didn't actually think that would work, to be honest.
Oh, it's a secret passage. Well, I think it's down there, Marmite.
Well, I have my suspicions, but I cannot be certain. We may be the first visitors to this chamber for nearly 1,000 years.
Oh. Well, there's no spiders down there, though.
Believe you me, in here, spiders will be the least of our worries. Little ones, anyway.
Allahu Akbar.
Your Excellency. Your Excellency, you might want to put that safety catch on. General Anton Giza is here.
Oh, no. What's he doing here? He's so aggressive.
You summoned him, Your Excellency.
I know. Can we tell him I'm not here?
He's already seen you.
Oh, fine. Let's get this over with then.
Your Excellency, General Anton Giza, Squire of the Kingdom of Blacktooth, Defender of the Imperial Crown and Head of the Hackett Armies.
All right, Puff.
Hello, General Giza. Do you look well?
Oh, what, you want to give me a Frenchie, do ya?
No. All I meant was you look good. You've got your new armour on and you look very dapper, that's all I meant. Let's just forget it.
No. Why don't you forget it?
All right, it's forgotten. Erased. There it is. Gone. Gone.
I was only pulling your leg.
Right. Did you get my memo?
What, the one that was covered in tears?
Yes, that one.
The one that I couldn't read because the parchment was all soggy because you was crying on it because you can't find a man with 11 fingers.
That's the chap, yes. How goes the search?
Well, one of my grasses heard a murmur. There was some bloke getting all jet to biscuit about your taxes down at the ruins. So I sent a drone down, and he's come back telling me he's eyeballed some 11-finger bloke poncing about in the gift boutique. You reckon that's him?
Was he alone?
No, he's with a midget and some fit-looking prat. What do you want me to do?
Well, I think what we should
do... This is what I'm going to do. I've got a garrison, a big, strong boy stationed down there. I'll send in a unit. We'll find him, carve him up a tree. How about that?
Actually... Here's the thing, General. I'd kind of like him alive. I wouldn't mind killing him myself, if that's all right.
Yeah, well, I'll see how I feel when I get down there. Some of the boys like to cut loose every now and again, don't you, boys?
I know. What about if I meet you halfway? You can do what you like to the other two, and I get to keep him.
Fair enough. So, I'll shoot down there, kill his mate, spring him back here, and then I'll fix your kettle.
No, I don't think there's anything wrong with it. Leslie, is our kettle broken?
No, it's fine, Your Excellency.
Then why ain't it on, then? I'm spitting feathers here.
Oh, yeah, I see you like a cup of tea. Leslie, may I make the General some tea, would you?
Yes, Your Excellency.
Yeah, none of that herbal muck, neither. Right, give us a go on your shotty. Pow!
Ha,
look around, then I began to kill. I killed a pig and a bear and a chicken and a dog and a moose and a fox and a calf and a frog.
You killed a pig and a bear and a chicken and a dog and a dog.
Up ahead, look. Light.
I think the tunnel widens into a larger chamber. Watch your footing, it may be booby-trapped.
Like in Raiders.
I hope we don't find out from Melina's body in here.
Melina's dead?
No, he's not dead. Forget it.
Here we are, the central chamber. For eons, scholars have argued that beneath the ruins of Moran's castle, there lay a secret room which contained the sulfur of time itself. While others maintained that the room was the location of an ancient finding device which would lead whoever could control it to the resting place of the sulfur.
Which do you believe, Marmite?
B.
So, Marmite, this ancient finding device, what are we looking for?
I'll know it when I see it. Come along.
Oh, why are you crying, little boy? There's no need to be frightened. Mummy's here. I can't see Daddy anywhere, though.
You took Daddy away.
No, I never.
I know who did. Mate of mine. Lovely bloke.
He told me your daddy cried like a big baby.
Please don't hurt him.
We're not going to hurt him.
But we're definitely going to hurt you.
So tell us what you know. Take your time. You've got 5 seconds left. Go.
There was a man in the gift shop.
One.
And he was complaining about the taxes.
Two.
And Timmy said that he had 11 fingers, but I swear I didn't see.
Three. Now you're in trouble.
Hello, boss. Morning, lads. Lovely day for it.
Hello, Geese.
Morning, boss.
Hello, dude.
Who called me dude? Did somebody call me dude?
I did, sir.
Don't.
Right. This is the kid, is it?
Please don't hurt him.
Now, normally, the sound of a woman crying is like a balm to me, but you are giving me the right hump. Please, not another sound. Now, Timmy, why don't you be a good boy and tell your Uncle Anton exactly what you saw?
I was in the shop with Mummy buying a stink of rock, and I saw a man with 11 fingers, and then I watched where they went.
Oh, General! We found an open chamber that's not on any of the site maps!
Good boy, good boy. Right, lads, take these two away. Take her to the Golga, stick a collar on the little one and take him to relearn in Camp 4. We'll make a man of you yet, sonny! Right, lads, look lively. We wrap this up nice and quick and I'll buy you all a pint and a fractured jaw.
Over here, lads, I found something.
What is it?
It is a brass-bound casket, very old. It is inscribed in ancient Gravish.
What does it say?
Sadly, ancient Gravish is a dying language. There are only a handful who understand it.
Are you one of this handful, Marmite?
Yeah, let me see now. It says something about a mussel rising from its grave to do battle with a giant gatto.
You're not one of this handful, are you?
No. Come, let's open the box. Behold!
A tiny gold statue of a samurai warrior. The sofa's virtually ours. Brilliant.
Watch and learn. Tiny golden warrior. Mushy, 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 mushy.
Oh, it's moving.
Speak, little one.
Oh, who amongst you is the chosen one?
Me. Me, I am.
Oh, really? Oh, then I bring you a message. I was placed in this casket 1,000 years ago. I was hoping this day would never come. The very fact that I am talking to you means the land of Gravia is in great peril.
Yes, it is. What should we do?
I will be your guide. Those that took and hid the solver of time from evil. Also cast me in the fires deep within Mount Billy Elliot.
Did you say Billy Elliot?
No. I continue. I will guide you to the solver's resting place as best I can.
How are you going to do that then?
I'll probably just point.
Ooh, oh, we're all safe.
Now, Parker, shut up. What's your name, tiny pointing warrior?
I am called Kabuki-san.
Then welcome, Kabuki-san. I am Marmite, son of Lobo. Oh. This is Parker.
Hello.
And this is Kelly, Parker's beau.
Hello.
And this is your new master, the savior of our world, the chosen one.
Oh, yeah.
It is a great honor, my lord.
Kabuki-san, will you join our number on our quest to rid the world of darkness?
Hi! Oh, that means yes. I was a bit bored of being in that box anyway. 1,000 years is a long time without sandwich.
Yeah, it is. I didn't eat once for 40 hours. Hallucinated so badly I had to pull a van over.
Silence, everyone! What was that?
I can't hear anything.
Arm yourselves. I think we have company.
I probably should have mentioned this before, but I haven't actually got a weapon.
What?
Don't have a weapon.
What did you do with all that money I gave you back at Bravemont?
Spent it on this helmet. The glass helm of Port Lock. Look at it shine. Ah.
Find yourself a weapon quickly, my lord. I think we are in trouble. I will go and investigate. Stay here.
No, what am I going to use?
There are weapons in the corner of this chamber. They are the weapons of fallen heroes.
What this big pile of dead knights?
Oh, that's a one.
Not touching them. They smell like muck.
Oof, shut up and grab a weapon. What's happening?
We are in grave danger. Hackett soldiers, 30 or more, coming up the tunnel.
Bloody hell. You ready, Kelly?
Yeah, I'm ready. Fetch me my harrows.
Oh, harrows. Marmite, what shall I do?
Parker, you pin them back. As they approach, fire your arrows into the tunnel. Buy me some time.
Come on then, Kelly.
Yeah!
Right, Kabuki-san. The way we came in is blocked by our enemy. Is there another way out?
There are 12 tunnels leading from this chamber. They fan out like the spokes of cartwheel.
Go on.
Well, that's it, really. I was just saying.
So, how do we get out?
I don't know. They brought me down here in a box. I'm made of gold. I haven't got X away better, you know.
Well, please try.
As you wish. Give me 5 minutes.
You got one, Kelly. It's easy. It's like shooting fish in a horizontal well.
Great shot, Parker. Keep firing.
They are nearly upon us.
They're swarming up the tunnel like mice up a toilet tube. Help me, Marmite.
Hold fast. I am with you. Kabuki-san, would you mind if I placed you in my pocket?
Pocket box? All the same for me.
Parker, I'm going in. Cover me.
Marmite, don't go up a tunnel.
Fire high, brave warrior. I shall run beneath the arrows.
Marmite! Where are you? Marmite!
It's no good! There are too many of them! Fall back! Fall back!
You're here, Marmite!
Oh, I know! It will hurt!
Oh, God, we finished! Milford! Where are you, Milford? Milford?
Hey, Mama! Cook me up a nice boiled egg! And it is I who shall provide the soldiers for this meal.
Hold your fire, everyone! Hold your fire! They are retreating!
Alright.
Yeah. Yeah, fine. Where did you get that?
Oh, it is.
Yeah, the old plasma rifle there.
Just ran it back.
Good. Nicely timed, sir.
There you go. Nah, I only had one charge.
Oh, the impression was rubbish. Hey, Marmite. Marmite?
Oh, no, he's hit. He's got an arrow in his chest. It's one of yours, Parker.
Yeah, sorry.
I never done it.
Marmite, are you okay?
I am fine, my lord. But you are still in great peril.
Look, Kabuki-san. Can you aid us? Which way?
Oh, I think I got it now. To escape from this chamber, I take the tunnel that leads north-northwest at 11 o'clock.
11 o'clock. Okay, thank you, Kabuki-san. Parker, pick up Marmite. Let's move!
Magic!
How many we lost?
40. And Sergeant Gooner, sir.
What? Gooner's dead? He was a bloody good soldier. Death was his life. Do you know, we used to stand on the terraces together down at Blacktooth Town FC. They called us the Dagger End Boys.
What should we do, sir?
Oh! Any of you lot know how to get rats out of a tunnel? I'll tell you. You flush them out.
Fetch me my siege hose.
It's getting heavy enough. I don't think I can carry it much longer. Oh. I need to stop for a second.
No way.
Shut up, I need to stop.
All right, look. Put him down. I think we've lost him. Oh. Okay. Marmite? Marmite? Oh, no, Parker. I think we're losing him. We've got to do something.
Let me think. Hang on. The mammy's milk. It's in his knapsack.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Hurry up. Come on.
Got it. Here you go.
Lift his head up.
Yep.
Sit deep from this draught, eh? My tiny pulse of chum.
Come on, buddy. Come on. That's it. It's working.
I think you're right. Still with us, Marmite.
Where am I?
He's back.
Don't worry, mate. The Ackett are gone. You're safe now.
You saved him, Parker.
Yeah, well, anyway, look, you know, we shouldn't escape. What? Did you say something, Mama? I didn't quite catch what you said.
You heard me. I said, thank you for saving my life.
Oh, shut up, it was nothing.
What's that?
What's what?
Listen, that sound.
Oh, I don't know, it's kind of sounds like,
Hang on.
Knocking
out too. What is that?
You know what? It sort of sounds like an earthquake or a freight train or...
What's the water? Water?
Oh, water! Oh, knockers!
Listening to The Sofa of Time, it starred Matt King, Nick Frost, Mark Heap, Peter Serafinowicz, Kevin Eldon, Julia Deakin, Janie Anderson, Daisy Jones, Simon Pegg. It was written by Matt King and Nick Frost. The producer is Mario Stilianides. Captain Chapel and the Crabs.
Oh, this is the life, eh? This is what I signed up for. Beach, sand between the old toes, and the roar of the ocean deep.
It's lovely. I'll tell you what, I'm just glad we're safe. It's so calm here.
Maybe a little too calm.
You what?
I said maybe it's a little too calm.
What are you on about, Marmite? This is paradise.
Something feels wrong.
Oh, don't be such a whinge, but I tell you what, here's a couple of francs, Milt. Why don't you see if you can't find us a couple of mivvies? Do you want a mivvy, Marmite?
What is a mivvy?
It's not a beachside refreshment. It's just a heart of smooth dairy ice cream wrapped in a cooling iced fruit crust.
Oh, a fruit rind, why didn't you say? I love a fruit rind. Go on then. See if they've got a Bingle Brain Burst. If not, I'll just have a raspberry ricochet.
Oh, that sounds great. I'll go a raspberry ricochet and whatever you're having, Milf.
All right then. Which way do you think I should go?
Probably just head back into the jungle there, or as I like to call it, nature's harder.
Okay. See you in a minute.
Uh-huh. Do us a favour, Marmite. Have some of that lotion on my calves, would you?
It's all right.
Oh, this really is blinding, isn't it?
No, no, he's gone!
Oh, who are? Who has?
Kabuki-san! Kabuki-san's missing! He's not here! I've searched everywhere. He must have fallen out of my pocket when we were washed down the tunnels. Oh, no! Oh, you are a foolish man, Parker.
You are?
Not only are you a half-wit, Parker, you are very much the smaller half. Don't you understand? How are we to find the sofa now? Kabuki-san was our only way. I'm not made of ancient pointing devices, you know.
It's all right, I'm sorry. It's been a while, hasn't it? We chatting up a local dolly bird somewhere.
Is he a hit with the ladies?
No, not really. He's only got eyes for the one girl.
She must be some kind of woman.
Well, you know, she certainly is a kind of woman. He left him, though, like they all do.
Where'd she go?
Well, since you mentioned that love coin, he thinks she's here. Oh. Hang on, there's Milf. He's down the beach.
What's he doing? He appears to be running.
I didn't drop them fruit ones. Has he got the fruit ones?
I don't believe he has.
Parker! Bye-bye! Run!
You are?
Run! They're coming out of the trees!
What are? Have you got the fruit ones?
You know what? There are no fruit ones on this island. Only crabs. Giant crabs!
Giant crabs here, on this beach.
Giant crab? When you say giant, are we talking like the ones at the Cromer Crab House giant, or... you know, more of a Boston seafood platter giant?
Harryhausen
giant!
What have you done, my lord?
I don't know. I saw a tiny baby crab and when I thought no one was looking, I kicked him in the pond.
And now we are about to be so...
Who's playing that harmonica?
I am, so far.
Give it him. You know you're not like that, you scumbag. And that.
All right. I don't know why you've been so crabby.
All right, shut it.
Well, this time we are indeed in trouble, no Kabuki-san. Banged up in crab prison and the sofa farther away than ever.
Yeah, why did you have to go and kick the Queen's nephew into a pond, you little div?
Oh, sorry, it just looks so kickable.
Oi, shut up! Who's that laughing?
Sorry, that's me, over here, in the opposite cell. The name's Chapel, Captain Michael Chapel.
You sound English.
Oh, yes. Sorry, man, born and bred.
What are you doing here?
Well, it's like this. My man and I were steaming south-south-east on His Majesty's frigate, the Lord Bowman. It was 06:30 hours when we slipped out of Guam, bound for Honolulu. I remember the sea. Flat as a mill pond. Probably why we didn't see the blighters coming. 1 minute, Drummond and Beaumont were playing sharp quiet up on the forecastle, and the next we were on our side, leaking badly, snapped bulkheads sticking through the deck like broken teeth. And fire. So much fire. I say, any of you chaps got a light?
Oh, I've got matches. There you go.
Thanks, old chap. Ah! Lucifer's. Lovely. Ah. Couldn't help but over here, you chaps appear to be in a bit of a pickle.
Yeah, we've lost our ancient finding device and...
Shut up! Raman Bod has spies everywhere. How do we know we can trust him?
How dare you, sir! I am a British officer serving in His Majesty's Royal Navy. If my credentials are in doubt, then ask me a question only an Englishman could answer.
All right, here we go.
Name two cities in England.
Bristol and Canterbury.
What's it?
Bristol. What's the
name?
What
town is it?
Yeah.
No idea.
City? Yeah. Okay. He's right. Yeah, he must be telling the truth.
Ah, good. Then forgive my distrust, Captain Chapel, for we are on a mission of great urgency.
Ah, a mission, you say? Then you need to get out of here. And as an officer in the Royal Navy, it is my sworn duty to assist you.
But, Captain Chapel, we're in Crab Prison. How can we escape?
Well, I've tried many times. Escape's not an option, I'm afraid.
All right, but what's going to happen if we don't escape?
Well, probably be dragged before the Queen and sentenced. And believe me, she won't be lenient. You kicked her nephew into a pond, I overheard. And that's treason. And the old girl's very protective of her family, since she lost her son.
Her son died?
Captured. The Battle of Pelican Rock. Word amongst the goons is it broke her heart. Never been quite the same.
Did you happen to hear where he's being held?
Some floating prison, I think.
The Golga?
Yes, that's the chap.
I see.
Hush up, chaps! Looks like they're coming for you.
Stay up, you lot!
So crabby.
Heard it. You three, the Queen wants to see you.
Oh, terrific.
Let your sticky pincers off of me!
Now watch it!
Silence! Bring them here! Which one of you did it? Which one of you kicked him in the pond?
Him! Shut up!
Was it you?
Yes.
Guards, take him away and pincer him in half!
What? No! Mama, please, pop her!
We can get your son back!
What did you say?
I said we can get your son back.
Silence! Who dare you mention my beloved son in here? Guards, kill them all!
No, please!
You can kill us now, or we can perish aboard the Golga trying to rescue your son. What have you got to lose?
No one has ever escaped the Golga.
The man you are about to execute is the only man in the world who can help you.
This king?
Yes. It may be hard to believe, Your Highness, but this is the one spoken of in the writings of Moran.
Him? Shut up! If this man is the chosen one, then he will have 11 fingers. You! Show me your left hand! No, the left one. It is true. You are the chosen one. Then you can help my son.
Yes, and I will help your son, mighty queen of the crabs.
Oh, to see my handsome son, the prince, once more. Guards, release them. Thank you, Your Majesty. We are most grateful for your leniency.
My generals will make ready for your departure. We will help you in any way we can.
Your Majesty, there is a man held here in your crab prison, a Captain Chapel. He's a mighty warrior from my homeland. Can he come?
What are we need him for? He was in the Navy. Haven't you seen Guns of Navarone?
Very well, you may have him. He is yours. Now, leave me. I wish to walk along the water's edge and remember with fondness my son's gay laughter.
Don't say a bloody word.
Where are our heroes? Ah, there you all are. Tell me, you ready for the off?
We are, Your Majesty.
You have my finest crabs at your disposal. And everything you should require is loaded onto the shells of our proud fighters.
You are indeed most generous, Your Highness.
Yes, you'd think. But there's no such thing as a free lunch. You didn't think I'd let you leave here scot-free, did you?
Actually, yes.
How do I know you'll return with my son?
Majesty, you have our word.
Not good enough, I'm afraid. I'm going to need a little insurance.
Well, I could leave my sovereign ring.
No, I don't think so, young man. Here's a better idea. One of you will stay behind.
What? No, there's no way we can't. We all go on the mission. Me. I'll do it. I'll stay behind.
Parker, what are you saying?
You sure?
Oh, yeah, I'll be all right. You shoot off on the mission and I'll stay here and await your triumphant return here on the... here on this beach.
Oh, that is brave.
Oh, yeah. Yes, brave. It's me, isn't it?
Splendid. It's decided, then. This will remain here. And if the rest of you aren't back in 3 days with my son, I'll cut the little tit in half.
Oh.
Bon voyage.
Lance on Gazer, Your Excellency, Squire of the Kingdom of Blacktooth, Defender of the Imperial...
Shut it!
Sorry.
Oh, here we go. General Gazer, how do you feel it went? Well, I hope.
Nah, not really. We lost the company of strong boys. Mate of mine got killed. And I also lost my good helmet. How do you think I feel?
Oh, well, I'm sorry to hear that. You do have my 11-fingered prize, though, right?
Well, I'm sure he's dead.
Would you have his body?
Nah.
Then how can you be sure he's dead?
Well, I can't be sure. We checked the tunnels as far as the border with Crustacea, but found no trace of him. We had to pull out in case we got spotted by a crab patrol.
So let me run this through me old mind, just so I'm clear. The one man who could bring to an end my evil reign of tyranny and destroy me and my plans to take over the whole world may not, in actual fact, be dead.
Nah.
He may, in fact, be the opposite of dead, which is... Anyone? Lately, you've got your hand up.
Alive?
Alive! Well done, Lately. So, you see my problem.
Right, well, what I'll do is...
No. We've tried it your way. Now we're going to dance to my drumbeat, Mr. Gazer. What you're going to do is this. You're going to take 8 battle groups.
What? That's almost 400,000 men, Excellency.
Yes, it is. And you're going to camp those men out in the Vale of Tsutan, beneath the Yutang Sinkalele Mountains, upon the banks of the Hamalalala River.
So, eastern?
Precisely.
Well, that's Crustacea. The crabs will see that as a declaration of war, Your Excellency.
A war they can ill afford. If the crabs have him, they will have no choice but to hand him over. You're forgetting, General Gazer, that I have their dashing young prince imprisoned aboard the Golga. A handsome bargaining chip, I'm sure you'll agree.
Nice one.
Yes, it is a nice one. And unless you wish to join the young crab prince, I suggest you scuttle out of here, General.
Your Excellency.
The scuttle gag worked really well, my lord.
Yes, it did. Lately, prepare my launch.
But, you've just eaten.
No, my launch. The Imperial frigate. I think it's high time we paid our dashing young prince a visit. Don't you?
You're a seafaring man, Captain Chapel. Any idea where we are?
Well, I can't see a bloody thing out here, but according to these charts, we shall be running into the Gog any time. Right, chaps. Seems we're here. Now, according to these crab charts, the Golga has 6 legs, each of which is a door leading to a service tunnel. We will enter here at the base of leg 4. You crab chaps, submerge and wait for our signal.
What is a signal?
I will release this brightly coloured songbird from this cage and... I'll just shout. Right, let's go!
Okay, James. If this crab map is accurate, behind this door should be a control room. From here, we should be able to take down the security system.
Does it show toilets on there? I'm busting for a wee.
Toilets? Yes, at the third and right.
Sorry.
Be quick, my lord. We have urgent work to do.
2 minutes.
Shh.
I'll be back in a minute. Then have a quick number 3. Lou. So, you were here for the security conference?
Yes.
Bloody bore, isn't it? You speaking?
No, no.
I am closing the whole thing.
Oh.
Not a big one for public speaking. They like it if I come and say a few words, keep the morale up, you know.
Yeah.
Wing.
Yes.
Anyway, I'll see you back out there. You hanging around for the nibbles?
Probably. Yeah.
What was your name?
Milford.
Oh, I shall remember that. Nice chatting to you, Milford.
Yeah. Bye.
Right, men. Game time. Weapons at the ready.
Mama, I'm really frightened.
Hold fast, my lord. Remember, you are the chosen one.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I can't die.
I never said that. Hmm? Okay, chaps. After three, in we go. Kill every one of the buggers. Last man standing puts the kettle on, right? Here we go. One, two...
I wish Parker was here.
Three!
Parker! Oh, I thought...
Are you all right, Master?
Yeah. Thanks, Kelly. I just had a bad dream. I hope Milford's all right.
He's probably dead.
Oh.
Hello, sir. I see you are awake. Oh. Can I get you anything else?
Yeah, go on then. I'll have another fruit wand.
Certainly, sir. And for your bow?
I don't got a mouth.
No, just one fruit wand, thanks, Jeffrey.
No fruit wands.
Where is everyone?
I don't understand. The place should be teeming with scobble.
Over here, chaps. Security monitors. Look, the whole belly lot of them in one place. Looks like some kind of a powwow.
Yeah, they're having a conference.
What? How did you know that?
I was just talking to the bloke there. He's giving a speech. Quite a nice bloke.
What did you say?
On the monitors. Just talking to him before.
This man here?
Yeah, it must be head of security or something.
He's not head of security, you fool. That's... Ramen board.
I'm sorry, what?
Is that corn or bear?
It is bad. Very bad. Oh, sweet Moran, if he had seen... It would have been the end. I don't understand. Why is Bod here?
Let's just go, all right? Can we go?
Easy, lad, easy.
Whatever his reason for being here, this may actually work in our favour.
Yes, this Bod chap could provide us with the distraction we need.
Indeed. Oh, sweet fortune. While they are watching him, we shall steal the prince from under his very nose.
Okay. Can we use these monitors to look at other parts of Golga?
Ah, clever. Pinpointing the whereabouts of the prince, eh?
Okay. No, look at all these prisoners.
No, stop. Go back. There he is. The crab prince. Good work, my lord.
Cell H9, two levels down.
Quickly, we have no time to lose. Ram and Bud's foul assembly could dissolve at any moment.
Tell you what, chaps. I'll stay here and monitor the... monitors, and if the meeting breaks up, I'll give you a signal.
All right. What's the signal?
I'll press this button. The meeting seems to be breaking up. Sorry, chaps. Can't resist when I see a bank of buttons. Awfully clumsy of me. Tell you what, I'll remain here and see if I can't disable the locks to the cells. If Jerry turns up, I'll fend the blighters off with my old service revolver, Barbara here. Yes, called a Barbara after an old flame. Barmaid, I was quite taken with. Jolly farmers and cobble. Last time I saw her, she was waving me off at Epsom Station. Single tear rolling down her soft, ebony cheek. This bloody war. Chaps?
H6, H10. Oh no, there's no H9.
You're doing the evens there, buddy. Odds this side. Here it is. Come on, Chapel, come on.
He's done it!
Your Majesty, we are here to rescue you. We have been sent by your mother.
Is that you, Mummy?
No, as I said, we've been sent by your mother.
Mummy's here?
No. Mummy sent us here.
So she's here, then?
Oh, shut up! What's wrong with him?
He may be drugged. The scobble would fear his strength. Quickly, you grab his pincers. I'll take the feeding prong.
You have 11 fingers. How could this be?
Who said that?
I did. Over here in the dark. My name is Fenlock DeSanto, the Sulfarians, the last of my kind. If you are who I think you are, young sir, then I have waited 1,000 years to meet you.
Sorry, I don't have a pen.
I don't think he's after an autograph. Fenlock DeSantos, you are correct. I am Marmite Marmicious, and this is the one you speak of. The Chosen One.
All Moran's children, I never thought I'd see the day.
Sir, you say you are of the Safaria?
Indeed I am.
The armies of evil are on the march. A dark lord has arisen and we are on a quest to stop him. Can you tell us the hiding place of the Sofa of Time?
There is no time to tell you. The Scobble are near. If you take this map, I have secreted away somewhere. No.
If you could hurry up.
Oh, here!
Thank you. Will you come with us?
It is a kind and generous offer, Chosen One, but my legs are old and frail. I would surely slow you down.
Cheerio, then. Thank you for the map.
One of you could give me a piggyback? Oh, shit.
Aboard the crabs, quickly, Your Highness.
Ah, my fellow crustaceans. How I have yearned to see my own kind. Take me home, Mummy.
Look, your mum's not here.
I know, Mummy.
Look, we need to wait for Captain Chapel.
We can afford to wait no longer, my lord. I fear our brave captain may have perished.
No!
Oh.
There he is! Captain Chapel, quickly!
Move over, Chapel. Oh. I see you have the prince.
Everybody aboard, mighty swimmer crabs, take us home.
You all right, Captain Chapel? We thought you were dead.
Not on your Nelly, old boy. Here, had a bit of a run in with that evil fella. You couldn't tell me he was a powerful sorcerer. Had me pinned down, firing very big thunderballs out of his peepers. Still, nothing Barbara couldn't handle. Eh, Barbara? Yeah, remind me. What was that fellow's name again?
Rahman Bod.
Yes, that's him. Ugly fellow.
No, I mean, behind you!
What?
No! No, Captain Chapel! Are you all right?
Oh, dear. Sorry, chaps. Appear to have had the old hull breached.
Marmite, can you do anything to save him? Have we got any mammy's milk?
No, my lord. Parker used the last of it on me back at the ruins.
There must be something we can do. Look at him. He's hit bad.
Don't worry about me, chap. Listen, Milford, old boy. Thanks awfully for getting me out of the brig. Giving me one last chance to stick one up, Jerry. If you're ever in Cobham, yes, and you fancy an ale, why not drop into the Jolly Farmers? And if you see Barbara,
yes,
the real one, I mean, tell her I love her.
I will. I promise.
I'm off now.
Don't die.
Milford, old boy, you wouldn't take care of Barbara for me?
Yes, the lady or the pistol?
I'm referring to my service revolver now. Oh. Take care of her. And if need be, pump a couple of rounds into Jerry for me, would you?
You can do that yourself when we get back.
Okay. There's no going back for me, old man. My war's over.
No.
Good everyone.
No.
Permission to come aboard, St. Peter?
No. No. I'm coming for you, Rahman Bod. I'll avenge the death of Captain Michael Chapel. And all those you've murdered, and imprisoned. I'll find the Soaper of Time, wherever it may be, and end your foul grip of tyranny here in Gravir. I vow this! I vow this by the power of Grayskull!
You've been listening to The Sofa of Time. It starred Matt King, Nick Frost, Mark Heap, Peter Serafinowicz, Kevin Eldon, Julia Deakin, Joseph Marcel, Daisy Jones, Simon Pegg. It was written by Matt King and Nick Frost. The producer is Mario Stilianides. Night of the Sexical.
And occasional rain.
Really romantic song there from Diamond Nights. Do you like that one, Mario?
I love it.
He likes that one. You can't see this, but he's got all five thumbs up. That was taken from their second album, Wanamaker Eggling. That one for Leslie, whoever you are. Just a little thank you from RB, who says, "You know what you do for me, and I just want you to know that I appreciate it." Ah, isn't that nice? Next up, the late night news headlines with Melinda Baltower.
Thank you, Jeff. The headlines this hour, the amassing of Hackett troops on the border with Crustacea continues, Crab Prince escapes from the Golga in daring prison break, and thousands line streets to pay their final respects to the well-loved actor Giganticus. Full details of those stories and more on the hour.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Barbaric race for crabs. Left me on my own for 3 days. My own mind to keep me company. Like a prisoner, I suppose. A human mind. No windows. Except the eyes. Windows to the soul. Pretty good. It's the same, Marmite, the eyes, the windows to the soul.
What?
A person's eye, oh, forget it. What's wrong with you two? What's up with Milford? He's been cleaning the captain's gun for the last 4 hours.
Leave him alone. Seeing a person killed in cold blood like that can do something to a man. I fear, Parker, that the Milford we knew has gone.
Leave it out. He's still the same, ain't you, Milf? Milf!
What? Oh, yeah, still the same.
Yeah, see? Told you, Marmite. Still the same old Milford, he won't change. He'll always be the same. Oh, well, we should turn in, get some much-needed shut-eye, eh? Good night, all. Good night, Kelly.
Good night, Master. Can I fire a harrow into somebody tomorrow?
Oh, harrow. Yeah, of course you can. Night then, Marmite.
Good night, Parker. Thank you.
Hey? Good night, Milf. I tell you what, we really have changed, haven't we? You and me? Really changed. Good night, buddy.
Good night, Parker. Marmite. Good night, Barbara.
The nights grow cold, Leslie. Throw another sack of paddocks on the fire, would you?
Of course, sir.
Oh, he was so close, Leslie. So close I could have touched him. He was standing next to me at the urinal. I didn't notice at the time, but he does have 11 fingers. And between you and me, very creepy.
Why didn't you take care of him there and then, Excellency?
But believe me, I tried. Some silly sod got in the way of my eye, Thunder.
Oh. Well, we will get him eventually, sire. Our spies tell me he and his group have crossed the uplands and have entered Blacktooth.
Blacktooth? There's only one way through those mountains. They will have to pass through Klausbergen. And when they do, I shall have a little surprise waiting. Ledley, go to the pregnant baby inn and find Morfina.
You're bringing the liquidator here?
No, no. I have a little job for her. Tell her to pack her woolly knickers.
As you wish, Excellency.
How much further, Marmite?
I cannot tell. The map given to us by Finlock de Santos is somewhat faded. But we need to rest. My Uncle Mortensen's house is in Klausberg, and it's in the next ravine. We'll encamp in there.
I think you'll find it's camp.
What?
I was just saying, there's no such word as encampen.
Oh, yes, there is. I encampen in your field.
No, you camp in my field, or you make an encampment in my field. You can't encampen anywhere.
Shut up! Stop bloody bickering. I'm freezing.
It's such a right for being skinny. I'm not going to walk because I'm quite fat. Probably means that you're going to die first.
No, I won't, because I can't die.
As I said before, not strictly true.
Are you Mortensen, Mum Mishes?
Yes, I am. Oh, the wind is ablaze. I must quickly rest.
If I could just take up a few minutes of your time, sir. Could you just sign this?
Yes, but the village, I don't have my quill.
I have a quill.
Thank you. Now, where do I? Heavens, I don't have my spectacles.
I have spectacles.
I shouldn't really. They're not my prescription. What about the village?
Never mind about the village. Just sign.
What am I signing?
Your death warrant.
Here?
Just there. Uh-huh. And one more here.
Yeah.
And if you could just initial here, and here.
What is this for?
Oh, you're just basically signing away your rights to life.
Why do you keep shooting me?
I love killing.
There! Klaus Bergen!
Oh, is it always on fire, Marmite?
Well, no. Oh, sweet Moran! No!
Marmite, wait, slow down! This could be a trap! Come on, Parker. We gotta go after him.
All right. Oh, Kelly, you awake?
Yeah.
Hey, get yourself ready.
No, not yet. Come on.
The whole place has been burnt down. Everyone's dead. First Captain Chapel, now this. Parker, this is my fault.
No, I won't hear of it.
Huh?
This could easily have been started by a faulty electrical appliance or, you know, a discarded match.
Look, what about the bullet wounds?
Well, anything might have happened, mate, you know? A blazing 44-gallon drum of methyl ether might have rolled through the front door of the local gun shop. Sets off a chain reaction. Every gun goes off simultaneously into people's heads and faces.
You're just trying to make me feel better, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
No.
That's Marmite! Parker! Shut up! Not funny.
I know it's not, but do you remember Uncle Ivan's funeral, that woman who grieved herself sick? It's just like her.
Well, yeah, it does. Do you remember her? All that, oh, he's gone, he's gone.
Gone!
Stop it. Stop. Straight face. Straight face. Let's go. All right.
Marmite, I'm so sorry.
Hold me, Lord.
Of course. Come here, come on. Come here. That's it. There you go. Go on. Let it all out. Come on, honey, that's it. Shh, 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 shh. Purge.
Yeah, I'm going to scout around outside, see if there's anyone left alive. I'll leave you two to it. Keep on a cuddling, as they say. Keep on a cuddling, but I'm off.
Right, my way, sorry. Grieve on.
Of course, the Frost Fair was the only festival. Uncle Morty used to fly us kids up to Klausbergen every year on the back of a tanadak. Then he and the rest of the men from the village would slaughter the poor creature in front of our very eyes, and we'd all cry at the imagery of it all. But we'd soon forget all that when we were roasting him up and tucking into a piping hot slice of belly bulb. And there'd be music and dancing, and then all the younger kids would gather round and stab the witch with their ice daggers, and us older boys would go off to the pumping house where we would become men. Oh, I miss the silly old goat already.
Sorry, you talked to me.
Oh, no, I was just reminiscing.
Milford, Mama, I found this woman outside in the snow. She's only just alive and unbelievably sexy.
Oh, I wonder who she is. Put her down, Parker. Put her down by the fire. She must be frozen.
The Hackett came, killed everyone.
I knew it. Ram and Bod must know where we are. And if he knows where we are, we must be on our guard. Was there anyone else out there, Parker?
No, just the sexy frozen woman there.
What are you saying, Mama?
I'm saying that Ram and Bod may have sent an assassin to kill us. And if he is still here, then he...
Could be a she.
Well, it could be a she. Or he or she may still be out there waiting for us to make a mistake.
Oh, then we should move. It's getting dark out there. This assassin could be right under our noses.
She could be inside.
Indeed. And the temperature will soon plummet. Quickly, Uncle Mortensen has firewood in his barn. The two of you fetch some logs. I will wait here and tend to this strange woman who I've never encountered in any of my visits to the village before.
Nice.
Yeah, it's a good plan.
Now then, young lady, let's get you warmed up. Why don't I make us some wolf herb tea?
Hello, Marmite.
What? Oh, you're awake. How did you know my... No! Oh, you're the assassin.
Definitely cold.
I'm telling you, Parker, it's cold out there, but South Georgia, it was colder than this.
No, that's because we were sitting still monitoring penguin numbers. It just, you know, it felt colder.
Yeah, maybe.
Steal them logs on the fire, buddy. Oh, hang on.
What?
Marmite gone, sexy lady gone too. Do you think he's a...
No.
Well, he's not here, is he? Bedroom door's closed. Uh-huh. You do the math. I know where I'd be if I'd thought out the sexical. Why don't we let's burst in?
You're joking, aren't you?
I bet he's having a sex. Come on, let's burst in. See his little arse.
Really?
Yeah, come on. Ready? Mm-hmm. One.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Oh, he's doing it! Oh.
No, he's not here. Is it? No, ain't you? Oh, he's left a note.
Read it. To me?
Oh, right, sorry.
Dear guys, the assassin was me, the woman, ha ha ha.
Didn't see that coming.
Well, I have kidnapped your friend Marmite and taken him to Ramabod's castle, where he'll be tortured badly and then executed if you do not give yourselves up for extermination in 3 days.
Oh, great.
Yours faithfully, Morfina, assassin to the court of Ramabod. P.S. Thank you for saying I was sexy, although I think my tummy looks a bit bloated in this leather murder suit. P.P.S.
Go on.
I look forward to killing you in 1,000 different styles.
Good! Great. Brilliant.
Right, well, that's it, isn't it? That's it. Change of plan. We're going after Marmite.
Hang on, eh? What are you, nuts? The thermometer says it's minus 50 out there. You'll be dead inside a minute.
You know what? I'm getting a bit sick of you telling me what I can and can't do. Oh. I'm going after him, whether you like it or not.
But you're
going
to freeze.
I'll take these furs. They'll keep me warm.
What are you doing? They've still got bits of flesh on them. They're not even cured properly, you idiot.
What'd you call me?
I called you an idiot.
Yeah, well, I may be an idiot, Parker, but at least I'm not a coward. I'm going after my friend, whether you like it or not, and then I'm going after the sofa of time. And do you know why? Because that's what heroes do, buddy. That's what heroes do.
Yeah, well, I think I prefer the old Milford. Milf, wait for me, I'm coming. Do you know why? Because I don't want to be left here on my own. Milford!
User to break, Your Excellency?
Yes, I'm well aware of that, thank you, Lately. Okay, you're up.
Baruga! Only one more, and you know what happens. That's it! Oh. 8-ball! Get your jeans off!
Oh, bloody hell. Oh. I wish I'd never invented that rule.
Off!
Oh, shut up! There, happy now.
Ooh, nice pins.
Shut up.
Your Excellency, announcing the arrival of Morfina.
Oh, hang on.
Half-naked Emperor here.
Your Excellency, I...
Oh.
Goodness, I can see why you're Emperor.
Oh, shut up.
I'm just kidding. I didn't see a thing.
Please, avert your murderous gaze for a moment, would you, Morfina? Ready. Now, what's in the bag? Is it... the bait?
Yes, sire. Just as we agreed.
Oh, you're ever so good. Turn him out, then. Let the dog see the rabbit. Leslie, ungaggle him.
Excellency?
Unbegagify him.
No, sorry, I still don't know what you mean.
Leslie, could I have a word?
Of course, Excellency.
You know, this has happened quite a few times now.
What's that, Excellency?
Picking holes in what I say. It's fine when it's just you and me mucking about, but not in front of the other employees, okay? It just belittles me. You make me feel small. There, I've said it.
Well, I'm sorry, I didn't realise I was...
It's fine, Liz, but just be aware.
Of course, I'm sorry, Excellency.
Forget it. Let's go back to work.
Yes.
Ledley, take the gag from his mouth.
Yes, Your Excellency.
Thank you.
No, you're not getting away with this, Bot. You killed my family, you killed my friends, but now he is here and he's coming for you.
Not bothered.
You can hold me here, Ramenbod. You can hold me here for all eternity. Torture me if you must.
Oh, really?
You can stick red-hot pokers in my ears.
I don't think we have pokers at the moment. Les, did the pokers come in?
No.
I suppose I could use a pool cue. That'd still hurt, wouldn't it?
You could sharpen it.
Use your cutlass.
Yeah, but, you know, then again I could just slash it in with my cutlass.
Yes, sire, but classically that wouldn't really be torture, would it?
Point taken. But what if I failed to provide adequate medical attention? Wouldn't that then be classified as torture?
Now that's why you're emperor.
Right then. Where's he gone? Oh, there he is. Wriggling away like a swamp claven. Guards, do us a favor. Kick that bag over here.
Yes, sir!
Ow! Ow!
Milford, I'm so cold. I don't know if I can go on much further.
I can't feel my strength.
Oh, don't worry, Kel. I can't feel my feet. And you know what? I reckon that makes us about even. Milford, we need to find some shelter and fast.
But maybe we could dig out some kind of crude snow cave with our hands.
Oh, great idea. And when we've done that, why don't we use our feet to build a snow car? And then we can get in the snow car and drive to a nice warm hotel in our snow car.
Don't be like that, Parker. I'm trying to help.
You're trying to get us killed is what you're trying to do.
Look, Master. A star.
Oh, yeah, look, she's right. It's beautiful.
I wish we were on that star.
Yeah, then you'd be complaining it was too hot.
I heard that.
Good, you were meant to.
What's wrong with you?
There's nothing wrong with me. What's wrong with you?
You know what? I never thought I'd say this, but I wish we were back at Pickering's. Oh, look at me and my 11 fingers. I'm the chosen one. I'm a kind of god.
Oh, shut up.
Oh, what are you going to do, eh? Smite me?
I might.
Oh, go on then.
It's not a star. It's a light.
What?
I said it's not a star. It's a light.
She's right, Parker. That is a light.
It could be a... could be like a herdsman's shack.
Definitely looks like some kind of building.
Oh, it might be a snow cave, eh, buddy?
No, I don't think it's a...
No. Come on. I mean, let's not fight, you and me. We got to stick together if we're going to get through this thing, eh?
Yeah. Oh, no, look. I'm sorry, mate. I just thought, you know...
I know you did. I know. I'm sorry. Come here. Give me some of that good loving, eh? Oh... Good lad. Listen, we're not at the woods yet, but where there's light, there's hope. Come on, before we bloody freeze to death.
Ah, look. Now that is a star.
So, Frey, your PRB, over.
2 minutes, boss.
Roger, call me when you're clear. 6-7, you found her yet?
Negatory, chief. You can't what she looks like.
Said she'd be wearing black armoured dress, air of snakes.
OK, I'll clang the bell again.
Roger. You all right, boys?
You're a taxi office.
What do you expect? Mobile snow disco.
You mean we can get a cab from here? Anywhere we want.
Where do you want to go?
We want to go to Ramenbod's castle.
You want to go where?
Ramenbod's castle, please. We need a fast cab. We're in a bit of a rush.
Don't go south of the Black River at this time of night. Besides, I've got no cabs, mate.
What? What do you mean you got no cabs? Look at all these drivers.
Sorry, lads. Couldn't get a driver to take you there for love nor money.
Mate, you want money? Well, he's got money, haven't you, Parker?
More money, yeah. Yeah, I got money. How much do you want, eh? Huh? 50? 100,000? Here. 150,000 francs.
Aye. 39 will take you.
Are you sure, 39?
Of course. No fare is too dangerous for one such as I.
Here we go. Oh,
thanks, 39.
Cheers, we really appreciate it.
Yeah, if you care to follow me, good sirs. Got a taxi's pop in the back. Come up.
Ooh, it is indeed Ellis Webber. I pity the fool who must walk out in a night such as this. But for you, gentlemen, no such discomfort. Mine is the blue one.
I'm no expert, but that's not a car.
It's a dragon.
No. This is a griffin. Elridge. Real smooth runner. Hey, girl. Here. Come on, in. Climb aboard. Time waits for no one. Hold tight! Here we go! Coming out of our pockets, isn't it? Now you've got these families of orcs coming in. Now, don't get me wrong, I've got nothing against orcs, but when they start taking our jobs, well, that's...
Listen, sorry. I don't mean to be rude or anything, but, stop talking.
Yeah, you racist.
Fair enough. You'd want the radio on?
Yes, please.
Ladysmith, Black Mambazo. Next up, the early morning news with Melinda Beltower. Morning, Melinda.
Thanks, Jeff. The top story this morning. Peacekeepers have left the disputed zone as skirmishes break out along the southern borders. The crab armies, led by recently escaped dissident Prince, continue to amass in Crustacea, while hundreds of thousands of refugees flee the southern states fearing the outbreak of war. Today, politicians meet in the Senate to ask the question, is this the beginning of the end of our world? And if so, where is the chosen one?
General Geezer, you look awful. I see you've lost an arm.
I'm all right. Crab done it. Pincered it off in the battle. I kicked his head in. How are you? You all right?
I am as well as can be expected under the circumstances, General. Why are you here?
Well, I've got a little bit of good news and a little bit of bad news. Which do you fancy?
Give me the good news first. I've had a shit week.
Right. Well, the good news is, while me and the boys were retreating through the crustacean tunnels, I found this.
What is it? Hello, my little friend. Excellent work, Anton. This is just the tonic I needed to pick me up. Today has started well. Now, you mentioned something about bad news.
Well, Cheryl's throwing me out again, ain't she? She went nuts. Cut all my suits and off with an angle grinder.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, so I need somewhere to crash for a couple of weeks. You'll put me out, won't you?
You know, I'm a bit pushed for space, actually, at the moment.
What, in this massive castle? You must have a sofa I can sleep on.
Well, the thing
is... Oh, come on, you've got a sofa. I can't believe you haven't got a sofa.
No, General Geezer. I do not have a sofa. But with Kabuki-san's help here, I will. I will.
You've been listening to The Sofa of Time. It starred Matt King, Nick Frost, Mark Heap, Peter Serafinowicz, Kevin Eldon, Julia Deakin, Janie Anderson, Daisy Jones, Simon Pegg, and Andrew Maxwell. It was written by Matt King and Nick Frost. The producer is Mario Stilianides. Episode 6, Here Comes Bod.
Oh, well, there it is, at last. Ramen Bod's castle.
Look at it. Those sheer black walls must be 1,000 feet high. Soldiers posted on the ramparts. These are the guard towers with the spotlights. How are we going to get in there?
We'll climb for victory.
No, really, though?
Not sure. Well, think of something, OK? But what I do know is that our friend is somewhere deep within the anus of that castle. And we need to get him out. Let's ride.
Walk.
Let's walk.
Hello, Gravier 642. Yes, hang on a second. General Geezer, Your Excellency.
Oh, give it here. Yes, General Geezer.
All right, boss, just thought I'd give you a belt. How's it going?
Yes, and how's it going? I'm quite busy, you know.
Well, put it this way. The crabs don't stay in the monkeys. We're killing them. What are you looking at, Hoskins?
That's just a head, sir.
Is it? Take cover!
Here it is,
I just lost 40 or 50 good boys. Look at them, they're everywhere. I've got Jenkins on my shoe.
Do you know, I can't make head nor tail of him, Lily.
It's my angry man.
All right, Paul. In your own time, feet shoulder width apart, hips nice and loose. Seize the wheel of pain, feed it through the hands anti-clockwise. All right? Nice and confident, Paul. Away you go.
Now?
Yeah, in your own time, Paul.
All right?
Whoa. Stop there.
Oh, I'm going the wrong way, aren't I?
Well done. Well spotted. This might help you. This is how I remember it.
Uh-huh.
When torturing somebody on the rack, it's always lefty-loosey, righty-tighty.
Oh! Okay.
All right. And relax. That was great. Lovely work, Paul. How did that feel to you?
Good. Just felt really natural.
All right, okay. Let's move on. The electro helmet.
Uh-huh.
Who have we got? The next victim is... Marmite Marmicious. Hello there, Marmite.
Hello.
Paul's our new lad here on the floor, Marmite.
Hello.
He's gonna have a pop at torturing you, if that's okay.
Evening, gents. How goes the pain game?
Oh, good evening, Your Excellency. I was just showing Paul here the ropes.
Ah, yes, of course. Hello, Paul. Good to have you on board. I'm the governor, I suppose you'd say.
Hello, sir.
You know Leslie.
Hello, Paul. How's your mum?
Dead.
Good.
We were just about to do the old electro helmets on Marmicious here.
Oh, excellent. So, Marmite, my spies tell me that the Chosen One is on his way. So, that just leaves one problem. I will ask you again. Why won't Kabuki-san tell me where the sofa is hidden?
You'll never get anything out of me, Bot!
Okay. Give him a zap, would you, Dr. Hook?
All right, Paul, do you want to...
Oh, yes.
Look, don't be nervous, Paul. Pretend I'm not here. Lily, stand back. Watch this. It's hilarious.
Oh, look at his little legs twitch, sire.
Hello. Yeah, I've got a letter from an assassin. She said to come here.
One second, please. Just come through. Do you have a reference number?
No. Not exactly. I'm here to see Bod.
Initial?
R.
Let me see. Bod, Ricky Bod, Ray Bod, Rudy Bod, Remlin Bod. Do you have a first name?
Yes, it's Rahman Bod.
Rahman. Oh, the boss. Right, that'll be on the gold clipboard. Here we are. Can I ask what it's regarding?
I'm the 11-fingered man spoken of in the prophecies, and it's about me bringing down your master's murderous house and once again restoring peace to the world.
Right. Just two ticks.
Whoa there! Right, last delivery of the day. One large box for Rahman Bod's castle. Cool. Bloody.
Who goes there? Friend or foe?
Oh, shut up, Dave, it's me, Scott.
Oh, hello, Scott.
Yeah, you're a bit of an official today, ain't you?
Well, sorry, mate, it's just some
Some prat set the alarm off and they've had to step up security. What's in the box? You know, I don't normally ask, but, you know...
No, it's tiger fa fa. It's tiger fa fa fa. It's tiger fa 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 feed.
Feed, fair enough.
Well, do we want to check it then, did they?
No, it'd be all right. Just stick it down the chute.
All right, what about the box?
Well, chuck the whole lot down. They eat anything that lot.
Oh, that was so easy. Just call me Parker or Troy. Oh, no.
Oh, still no Joy.
No. He's supposed to point to the hiding place of the sofa, but he just keeps spinning round. Ugh, why won't you work? What's wrong with you?
Nothing wrong with me. What's wrong with you?
Oh, you're so bloody annoying.
I'm not annoying. You are.
I'll get that, Your Excellency. Hello, Gravier 642. Yes? I see. Here? Oh, good. Very well. Your Excellency, you won't believe it. He's here.
Who's here?
Him, sire.
Oh, really?
Just handed himself in at the front gate.
I didn't think that would work.
No.
Lately, why don't you go down to reception and escort our guest up to the Faversham suite? And I shall go and put on my frightening armor.
Shall I just bring him straight in, Your Excellency?
No, Lately. As we discussed, I think I'll lean against the mantelpiece, gazing mournfully into the flames.
Why didn't you just say, use the Behegan entrance maneuver? I'm not an idiot, you know.
No, look, Ledley, I just... Oh, Ledley!
Hello. I'm Leslie, equerry to His Excellency Rahman Bard.
Oh, hello?
Hello. Well, very well, if you'd like to follow me, my master awaits.
All right.
Oh, you're having some work done, I see.
Yes, yes. I don't know what his nibs thinks he's up to. One minute he's lining the plunge pool with black marble, then he's having an Andurian steam chamber fitted. Now he wants to have these two walls here knocked through so we can put in a sapphire viewing dome.
Oh, right. Your master certainly has flamboyant tastes.
Well, you should see his dojo. Well, come along. Now, if you'd like to look up there...
Milford's gone in through the front door to provide us with a distraction. That way we can look for Marmite and hopefully set him free.
We might kill Milford.
Aw, he'll be all right.
A guard.
Stop killing everything. That was a milkmaid.
She had a gun.
It was a pail of curds. What's wrong with you?
Bloodlust.
Bloodlust.
May I present to you His High Excellency Rahman Bard, 27th Duke of Broken Spire, Dark Earl of the Foul Mountains, Lord Mayor of Hades New Town and surrounding district.
So...
I haven't finished yet. And the most evil Emperor Warlock to threaten Gravier in 1,000 years.
Oh, Lately, you're making me blush. It's good to see you again, my fine 11-fingered friend. But why don't we get the pleasantries out of the way? Lately, you've met. And of course, you already know. Marmite.
Oh my God, Marmite! What have they done? What have they done to your beautiful face?
Eh? What do you mean, they didn't touch my face?
Look at me? Oh, no, sorry.
Now then, one of my spies tell me there was one more amongst your party. Where is he?
He was killed.
What? Oh, no. My lord, Parker is dead.
Yes, yes, Marmite. Trying to cross the marshes of Shid. He drowned.
Good. He must be starving. Please, don't stand on ceremony, chaps. Tuck in. Plenty for everyone. Especially now your friend's dead.
I will never dine with you, Ramen Bod. After everything you and your minions have done to the people of Gravir and those I loved, I'd rather eat my own bum sausage than sit at your foul table and... Ooh, crisps.
No, no, don't eat them, my lord.
Huh? Oh. All right. I can't die, remember?
Oh, why does he keep saying that?
Oh, don't worry, my mate. It's not my style to be so crude. I would never stoop so low as to poison the snakes. I have something far more explosively violent in mind. Please, be seated.
This is nice. It's lovely.
Now to business.
Let Marmite go and we'll talk, Ramen Bod. That was the deal.
Well, I don't see why I should, really. Thanks to your little stunt aboard the Golga, rescuing the Crab Prince, the Crab Tribes have reunited once again. They're proving to be rather tiresome. But rest assured, my superior Hackett forces will overcome. Peacock pie, anybody?
Stick it up your ass!
Why don't I stick it up your ass?
Mama, no!
Relax. He'll live for now.
So, what do you want with me, Bod?
I want you to finish that last mouthful of pie. And then... I'm going to cut your stupid head off.
No, Your Excellency!
Why did you do that, Leslie? You put me up by stroke.
I fear it unwise to kill him just yet, sire. Until we can get Kabuki-san to point to the sofa, we may still need him.
You're right. Good call, Leslie. Guards! Take this fool down to the dungeons!
Get off! You're hurting me!
I'll hurt you in a minute, boy.
Get in there!
I wish Parker was here.
I am here!
Parker?
Well done, you. Your plan went well, I see.
Oh, look, shut up. Look, just get me out of here.
Oh, yeah, all right, yeah, yeah. Good idea now. Why don't I put the cell keys? Cell keys.
Oh, yeah, you know what I mean, Parker. Oh, look, grab that rope on the wall. I've got an idea. Yeah, the base of one of these cell bars looks a bit corroded. Maybe with you pulling and me pushing, it might snap.
All right, okay.
Hurry up.
All right, done. You ready?
Yeah, ready.
Okay.
One.
One.
Two.
Three.
Pull! Well, that worked.
You all right, then?
Yeah, yeah. You all right?
Oh, yeah, if it weren't for me falling through this crumbly old wall, I could have been badly injured.
Hey, hey, you found another room, Parker. Oh,
have I? I've got loads of dust in my eyes. I can't see any.
Look! It's the sofa of time.
It's so beautiful.
Oh, Marmite was right. Every golden stitch and every jeweled button does throb with Moran's life force. Look at it. Parker, we found it.
Do what you gotta do, chosen one, and let's get out of here.
Yeah. Oh, hang on. What about Marmite? We can't just leave Marmite.
Marmite?
Oh, too late. Guards!
The prisoner has escaped. Arrest them both.
No.
What is this infernal racket you're making down here? I can hear you from the mustachery. Oh, you. You really are proving to be a rather bothersome ninny, aren't you? Mm. And who's going to pay for all this damage? Eh?
Wait a minute. What are you hiding there?
Nothing.
Move. What on gravier is that? It looks like... Oh. Bloody hell.
That's it. I've had enough. The Kabuki sun is not working, but I have the chosen one. And you, Marmite, I only used you for bait.
Kill me if you must, but a martyr is a very dangerous thing. The people of Gravier now know of the chosen one. The tide is turning against you, Bod, and when I die, a million more will rise up to take my place. Face it, Bod, you're a failure. For all your gesturing, you don't even have the sofa of time.
I got it!
What?
What?
I said I got it! I know where the sofa is!
Where is it?
Your Excellency!
What is it, Lindy?
I've got something for you.
What is it?
Have you been a good boy?
Oh, come on, Lindy. Not in front of everybody.
All right. Close your eyes.
Okay.
All of them. Good. Okay. Bring it in. Yes. Come on. Careful.
I grow weary, Lindley. Come on. This isn't a game of animal grab.
All right. And open them. What is the sofa of time?
Give it to you! Where did you find it?
It was hidden in the old catacombs of the monastery. We must have dropped the castle right on top of the bloody thing. Out under our feet.
That would explain why I couldn't point to it. It had a million tons of fortress on top of it.
Okay.
Our guests return.
Leave us alone.
Parker!
Marmite!
You're alive!
Oh, so this is the mystery man back from the grave. Well, don't get too comfy.
It's good to see you, Marmite.
Oh, it is good to see you too, Parker.
And so my victory is complete. And you're all here to witness it. I couldn't have planned it better myself. So, time for a little test drive. Hop on, Ledley.
You bet, Your Excellency. Oh.
Now then, insert the date, dimension oscillator primed, and the ticket. I just press these little buttons.
The sofa has an 11-fingered mechanism. You can't start it, Bod.
Got it.
What?
Your victory was short-lived, Bod. That's why the prophecy spoke about me. Only I can operate the sofa of time.
Yes, I can see the funny side. Guards! Hold out his left hand. No, no, his left.
No, no, what are you doing? No, my hand!
Now I have 11 fingers.
16, sir.
What? Oh, yes. Quite. Ready for the off, Ledley?
Yes, Your Excellency.
Oh, and by the way, Milford, I have a little gift for you. I believe you have the other half. Catch!
What? I don't understand. This is her half of the love coin.
Yes. Yes, it is. I didn't quite make the connection until I saw your half. And then it all fell into place. She made a pretty prize. And between you and me, Milford, I think she enjoyed being with her. Real. Cheerio.
No! Let me go! Let me go!
Sir! Rex!
Master!
Master,
over here! I'm coming, Kelly! Milford, catch my bonds!
There you go!
Master, behind you!
Thanks,
Marmite.
Yay! Got another one!
Ledley, what are you doing? Put that hand back on your controls! Ledley?
I have an arrow in me, sire.
Oh. Ledley? Hang on, you'll be all right.
No. I don't think I will.
Ledley, you can't leave me. What about our dream?
You can still buy the pub.
Not without you, Lid. Please don't die.
I can see my mum.
What?
Oh, not interrupting anything, am I?
General Gizzer.
Hello, boss. Look, bad news. The crabs have done us. They're swarming through the front gates, pincered your lovely portcullis in half.
Good, good. Lid! Lidley! No! Not now! When we're so close! I can't do this without you! Lid! Lidley! General Geezer! Bar the doors! Nobody gets out alive!
No problem, boss. Courageous last stand. I get it.
Coughs.
General Geezer!
You're finished, Bob. Look around you. Your general lies dead. Your whatever he was, Leslie, is gone. It's over.
Please don't hurt me, Milford. I'm a broken man. You've won. You were the chosen one after all.
Yes, I am. Now get off my sofa!
Get off this sofa when it's a cold day in...
My lord, he has a dagger!
What?
Ledley! Wait for me!
It's over.
Rahman Bod is dead.
So, the prophecies were true.
How's the hand?
Oh, not too bad, mate. The crab medics have cauterised the stump. I'll go to A&E when I get back.
Are you sure I can't persuade you to stay, my lord?
Oh, I'm sorry, Marmite. We have to go. There's things I need to do. What will you do now?
Oh, I will stay here and help the Crab Queen rebuild the kingdom. She's offered me a position in her court.
Oh, nice, nice. Well, thank you, Marmite, for everything.
Will I ever see you again, my lord? My friend?
You never know, Marmite. You never know. You nearly ready, Parker?
Nearly, mate.
Please, can I come with you, Master?
No. Be a good girl. Stay with Uncle Marmite. He'll take care of you.
But...
No. Promise me you won't kill anything.
I can't promise.
Bye, Kelly. Come on, let's go, buddy.
Yeah. Goodbye, Kelly. Bye, Marmite.
Goodbye, my lord. Be safe.
I will.
Goodbye, Parker.
See you, Marmite. It's good to meet you. Have a cloven loaf for me tonight, won't you?
Right. Come on in. Stick my hand on that control panel, Parker.
You got it, buddy.
Let's go on.
Well, here we are then, mate. Home at last.
Yeah.
We saved Gravier. Not bad for a couple of idiots, eh?
Yeah, we did all right.
Yeah, we did. Come here.
Oh.
Listen, man, I'm just sorry you didn't find her.
Hey, that's okay, mate.
Hang on, your hand's back.
Yeah, I know it is.
I don't get it. I saw your hand cut off. If it was cut off...
Parker, I'll see you tomorrow. In the grapes, yeah?
I doubt that. The grapes burned down last year.
Did it. Did it.
I'll see you later.
Hello? Hello?
Milford? Is that you? You've been gone a long time.
Yeah. Yeah, I have.
I can't find my half my love coin. You haven't seen it, have you?
Yeah. I've got it right here.
Sofa of Time. It starred Matt King, Nick Frost, Mark Heap, Peter Serafinowicz, Kevin Eldon, Julia Deakin, Daisy Jones, Simon Pegg. It was written by Matt King and Nick Frost. The cast would like to thank the Blue Tones, John Whitehall, Claire Bartlett, Darren Williams, Brian Creese, Paul Dealey and Vanessa Spring. The producer is Mario Stiglionides.